Your idea, it has been in my mind, but today program is a different case altogether. Normally, I am here. I have been here for those that have been following me for long. I am for the emancipation of our people mentally because of the religious, infliction that has been on them, and that is the basis of our problem, and that is what we are fighting to chase out in the minds of our people. Yes, to worship God is good. But the version by which people are doing it in Africa, it is what is that is what I don't understand, and that is what is driving most of us crazy. And the more we talk, the more stupid they become. But I know they say necessity is the mother of invention, and I have been on that journey, and then I have to encounter a kind of a disturbing information and news, and which I witness about a particular set of people, being sworn that they will not be alive to see the mankind breed. And today I'm going to show you a proof that tell you that these people don't reason. No matter how intellectual you think they may be, when they speak, you know that they don't have anything upstairs. And I have a lot of video here. I don't know where to start, but I know many you have seen, most you have never seen. But what in all you have never seen is that you have never seen it being analyzed in this way. And I am not here to create enmity. I am not here to play saga. I am not such person. I am here to say the way it is. I am here as open person who is always ready to accept his fault or mistakes. Like I was being corrected by our brother. I think what he said right away just makes sense to me. He said, Methuselah is supposed to be an emblem. And without overpomposity, I have to realize that what my brother said is supposed to be true. Even though on my second thought, I was thinking, no, maybe at the finishing time, I have to play it. But I think it's a welcome idea, and I respect that. And that is why we as a human being are supposed to be reasoning. Don't make yourself Mr. Know-it-all or Mrs. Know-it-all. You have to be flexible in your way of reasoning so that when you see an idea that can be able to lift you up from your current level of exposure, you can be able to grab it. And knowledge is power, information is power. And in as much as you just allow yourself to, be flexible in nature, you will never, never suffer. You will never be daft in nature. If you watch those philosophers in Greek, those that did philosophy during your school days, they have school of thought. What is the meaning of school of thought? Is where both Plato, Aristotle, Socrates, Francis Bacon, Thomas Aquinas, Pythagoras, all of these intellectuals, they have a school of thought where they go together and reason, and everybody will bring their idea. This one will say God exists because of this. This one will tell you God does not exist because of this. Most of these philosophers, they prove that God exists through motion. Just bring us something and back it up with idea. And that is why we are here to say the way it is. I'm gonna show you something today. That is why I told you, whenever you are listening to somebody, always be very, very ready to make a research. Don't swallow whatever somebody's saying. I'm gonna show you something that as I was listening to our leader Mazen Nnamdi Kanu today. It's not that what he said today, one of the things he said today, it has been in my mind. And one of the things he also said today is what I'm prepared today to show you guys. And as he's talking, all we know that there's a concussion in the names that we bear. And the thing came to my mind. Immediately he mentioned Port Harcourt and went immediately. And to shock you, and additional knowledge, the name itself. The man that have that name have never stepped his foot before in Nigeria. Never, never in his life. And secondly, he's a rapist. Not even a rapist. When I talk a rapist, he is a pedophile. And I'm gonna show you so that when somebody say I'm from Port Harcourt, imagine somebody telling you I'm a pedophile. That is what the person means. Now let's go. I saw it an essay written by a foreigner. I saw it again written by an indigene of Biafra land where they were calling him rapist. I said, no, I have to switch on to Wikipedia to see it all on myself. Now let's go. Let's go and see how, in the first place, though it wasn't to my today I mean program, but I have to because I listened to what today so that I can solidify and therefore you to believe that what this man is preaching is nothing but truth. Now, where is him? Where is the man exactly? Look at it. Look at the man here in question. His name is Lewis Harcourt. You know, when you say port of the Harcourt, and this is it here. This is the man. This is the pedophile. This is a pedophile. When you say you are from Port Harcourt, does this person look like your grandfather? Does he look like your great grandfather with mustache? Maybe this is why Wike is keeping mustache. Who knows? To replicate and to represent exactly a replica of what they are saying about him. This is Lewis Harcourt. Now let's go to read. This is not from any African country. This is not from a Biafran. This is not from Igbo speaking Biafran, not a John, not any of these black nation, but this is written by Wikipedia, and you know who handle Wikipedia is also them. Now let's go. Let's go. This is Lewis Harcourt. Lewis Harcourt is Harcourt First Vanguard Harcourt PC, born Reginald Vernon Harcourt is his name. 31st of January 1863, and the idiot died on 24th February 1922. He was a British Liberal Party politician who held the cabinet post of Secretary of the State of the Colonies. You see the position? Secretary, the ordinary secretary. Secretary of the State for the Colonies from 1910 to 1915. Lord, they put it Lord. Lord Harcourt's nickname was Lolu. And that had it been his that name, maybe if you see Lord Nam the Canon now, then you see everybody. All the monkeys will start jumping from their holes because they call him Lord. Now let's go to what this man, how the name came to be. Where is it here? This is Port Harcourt. Let's go. Let's go. Port Harcourt, capital of River State, is southern in southern Nigeria. It's named after him. When the port was established in 1912, there was much of his action, there was much controversy. I want to be very, very slow in reading so that if I have an old woman who is following, she can be able to follow up. Let me start from the beginning. Port Harcourt, capital of River State in southern Nigeria, is named after him. When the port was established in 1912, there was much controversy about the name he should receive. In August 1913, the Governor General of Nigeria, Sir Frederick Lugard, wrote to Harcourt. He wrote to him, not that he's on ground. He wrote to him, then Secretary of the State for the Colonies, that in the absence of any convenient local name, oh my God, in the absence of any convenient local name, which should be your name, can be Port Okereke, Port Nwachukwu, Port Chimezie. But Lord Lugard said, in the absence of any convenient local name, I will respectfully ask you your permission to call this Port Harcourt. The Secretary of the State replied, it gives me pleasure to accede to your suggestion that my name should be associated with the new port. Oh, this is very, very unbearable. And the problem I'm having now is not because of the name. Anything can happen. Anything can happen because they forced us. Whatever that is going on, they forced us to do whatever. And my worries now is what is going on now. Why can't you change that name? Now you want to claim that have left you people alone. Why can't you change the name? Why retaining the name? Not that you are retaining the name. You are protecting. You can even kill your own fellow black man to retain that name. That is to tell you, somebody you are bearing the name have never stepped his foot in that area. Lord Lugard, I have to call him by the way people address him. I don't care what you say that he's not Lord. The Lord Lugard, Frederick Lord Lugard, put a phone across. Yeah, Harcourt, please. In the absence of no indigenous local name, may I take your permission, indulgence to call this in your name? Maybe the man in his office or he's in the toilet. I don't know where you may be. I say yes. You can go on. It's a pleasure to have a name seated with my name. And when we are talking, you people don't understand. When this man is shouting, I know where he is heading to. You know? So Now we have read about this man. Let us know and see how his people describe him. This is Wikipedia, not me. Not Nnamdi Kanu, not Biafrans, not IPOB members, not even the so-called Nigerians. Let us see the lifestyle of this man. Oh, white people. If it is black people, they will not put it like this. What you are going to see now, you will never believe it. What you are going to see now, you never believe it. This man is a rapist. Look at the how they describe him. The same Wikipedia. Sexual misconduct. Harcourt was known in London society as a sexual predator of the young for both genders. Mumuoko mumuanyi. Omaakuruguru under 12, 13, 14, both women, and this man is raping. I am not the one writing. So that you tell me I will go to see this guy for lying against a British citizen. No, it is in their Wikipedia, not me. Harcourt was known in London society as a sexual predator of the young of both genders. You know, he attempted to sexually assault Ruth Brett, the daughter of Viscount Esther, allegedly a fellow pedophile, when she was about 15. May God have mercy on you people. These are the people. This is the name people are just killing their fellow Africans to protect. Look at who, you know, who just created the name. When she was about 15, Dorothy Brett wrote of him that it is so tiresome that Lolo is such an old rogue. He is as bad with boys as with girls. He is simply a sex maniac. For those that know the meaning, this is something that we have nymph, just like nymphomaniac, nymph, you know, sex maniac. He is prone to sex at all level. He doesn't care, maybe even animal. It isn't that he is in love. It's just ungovernable sex desire for both sex. This is where you people are calling Port Harcourt. This is why people are killing their fellow African to protect. I remember when we were saying, nobody should call this thing. This is Port Harcourt. Nothing like you, Gotcha. You begin to see the pure animalistic brain of a black man. That is why sometimes when we speak, we try to calm ourselves down, because if I begin to use what I see there and start talking, sometimes I may talk as if I am not, I'm not learned. Let me just put it in that way. I have to calm my tempo down, because when you speak about the madness going on in where we come from, you tend to be mad yourself. So this is all about this. Have it clear to you. Go and check it on your own self. Don't allow somebody to be doing everything for you. Now I have showed you at your free time, you took your time to read about this man. Number one, he never set his foot in Nigeria before. Number two, he have never been in Port Harcourt before. He have never had any position there. Just that he was in far away London. Just secretary, ordinary secretary of the African colonies. The secretary of the slaves. You know, when we say colonies, you know, they are using another word. You know, so these are the... He's the secretary, and can you imagine what this guy said? Can you imagine? Only this alone can even make people go crazy. How did he say it here? There was much controversy about the name he should receive. The governor general of Nigeria, Safedi Lugard, wrote to Harcourt, then secretary of the state for the colony, that in the absence of any convenient local name, I don't have to use English, Igbo, to translate, because many that are watching me, many of them are not Igbo speaking Biafran. But let me just show you, but we are slaves for this language. Everybody's supposed to understand it. Look at it here. It was written by hyphen. Look at it here. In the absence of any convenient local name. Local. I don't know. Let me use this thing to highlight it so that you can be able to know what I'm talking. Look at it here. Look at. In the absence of any convenient local name. Really? In the absence of any convenient local name. No convenient. No one is good. No one. They are just not. They are baboons. So, you know, to use the name of a monkey to come and give them, you know, in our presence, Let me call somebody far away from London. That is, by the way, let it not divide my attention. I am here for the Bini people, Ile Bini people. I am not trying to pull you down, but I'm trying to bring your history to your doorstep. I am trying to tell you your anger. I have started discovering it. Do you know last time I had I am still having my woman have started seeing me somehow. I think I called her yesterday and tried to differentiate the Biafrans from the Ile Ibini people. Because the call she heard from one of them, she was not comfortable. And I tried to clarify. You people should try to identify who is who. Do you know, remember when Ogiso finished speaking with me? Do you know there's a guy in that call and said what Ogiso said was a lie? You remember? The guy wrote me that he would like to speak with me because I try to reach out to everybody. I don't care who you are. If you like, be my even if be old enough to be my child or young enough to be, I will still pick your call. The guy called me. I pick his call. We are speaking. You know, he telling me, as you forget that guy, he's not the real Ogiso. It's him that is Ogiso. You know, everybody have his opinion. And I ask him, do you know that Ogiso that is talking, Murphy, I am referring to, Murphy said they naked his father. Oba went to the father, draw him out, naked him before the public, and making videos and pictures. You know what this guy said? The guy said, yes, that he deserved more than that. That he is even lucky, his only nakedness. That they take Oba, that after God, you get Oba. Because I put it last speaker and my wife heard it. My wife asked me, where is he? I say he's in London. So he's saying that somebody's father, somebody speaking out in Germany. You now go to the village to naked the father. And somebody is justifying it that yes, what the Oba did was right. So I call my wife and say, no, please, don't think like that. These are Ile Ibini people. We are not the same with them. Even though we may look alike. But that's a difference. Because you know white people, they have the reason. Like, had it been Wikipedia is being handled by black people. You see this information, you will not see it there. You will never see it. You see how they describe this guy as a sex predator, a pedophile. You see it here. If it's a black man, you will not see this information. They will delete it. That is the difference between we and the white. It's not that I'm trying to be safe, hatred or whatever. I'm trying to explain to them the guy that said the father, the justified to naked.
And
he's in London. Enjoying free speech. Trump, freedom of speech.
He should go home.
I mean, why would he go home? A baboon go home. They know what they're doing. They want to pull everybody down. Somebody speaking far away Germany. You didn't even go for him and naked him. If it is Murphy, they're naked. It will be, even though it's not okay, but it will be a little bit considerable. But you went and in the village, naked the father, make a picture of him, make a video. And somebody that is living in London, a well civilized place, is telling me that what they did to the father in the village is justified. That they should have even done more. I have to calm myself down, and what I want to show you now. No.
But it's pains.
It's painful. It's painful. I know. That's how we reason. You have to bear with us. That's why we are fighting to make sure that everything normalizes. Let me now show you a proof that. No. Sometimes it's painful. It's painful. It's painful. But what do? Let me play you a clip of these people. I have played it before for those that are just joining. I want us to analyze this clip one after the other to tell you that these people, both the one you think they're educated, they know nothing. Their brain is empty. Forget about the grammar. They can come and blow grammar. you know, below to the highest echelon. Their brain is empty, empty. You will see one of their who the fastest scholar speak. I say, really? Exactly. I brought it. Let's go. Let's analyze this.
2 years ago, and we're still on it.
Wait. And now the man now said they are. You know, I told you that I must find the reason why these people are so head bent on hearing about Biafra. I am getting it. I told you, if you embark on a journey and you are serious, you must discover it. This man said one of it. Listen, let us pay attention to him. They call him Obaseki. You know him. These are the people that are claiming ancient Benin. Let us listen to him. Most of the things he said, he's correct. But let me now tell to tell you that these people are nobody. Their brain is empty. Don't let somebody use name and grammar to destroy you, to intimidate you. You see, this is our sister that is speaking from Sweden. I think it's Sweden. Owas. If you listen to her, you will know that that girl is making sense. But some people will come and write, yeah, you don't know how to speak English. Your English is bad. Go back to the school. English is not our language. I am here, I speak another man's language. I cannot be proud of my own, but I'm claiming another person's language and how to speak it correctly. I'm trying to tell you, common sense is not by blowing grammar. Let us pay attention to him, and we are going to analyze it one after the other. This is it. This is the man. And the studio of, I think this is a daughter of Ibunedion or whatever. Let's go.
I've heard of you talk about the Midwest movement a few years ago, and you're still on it.
Yes.
Why have you taken, thought of doing this?
Many people still are very, I don't want to use the word myopic, about the history of Nigeria. Everybody in the United Kingdom will mistake the United Kingdom for England.
Mm-hmm.
But we all know that the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland is made up of four home countries.
Yes.
Nigeria, when we got independent, it was 3 years before independence, they were supposed to be made up of six regions.
Yes.
The six regions were the Northern region, the Middle Belt region.
Pay attention. I want you, please, we are going to deliberately, analyze this. I want you to be jotting things that is so important to you. I just want to debunk this man here. So that after finishing analyzing all these jargons, he is going to vomit. You begin to see that not speaking grammar is common sense. Really? He said Nigeria is supposed to be six. Who says so? How? Nigeria is supposed to be six region. By who? Are you the British that came to do the analysis? Were you among them? Let him finish. Let me allow him. That's a play. I will not. This is 24 minutes. Let us see whether we can accommodate it. But there's a lot of things, important things I want to show you.
Nigeria, when we got independent, it was 3 years before independence, was supposed to be made up of six regions.
Yes.
The six regions were the Northern region, the Middle Belt region, the Western region in Ibadan, the Midwest region in Benin, the Eastern region in Enugu, and the core region. The core region was to be in Calabar, and it is referred to as Calabar or Gorja rivers. That is the areas that is the minority speaking parts of Eastern Nigeria.
Minority. They are the one creating this nonsense. Somebody will be minority in his own place. Minority. Just like you are waking up from the morning. Somebody come here and tell you, you are minority. In my own house.
But at the constitutional conference at Lancaster House here in the UK, just prior to independence, it was agreed that upon independence, Nigerians can now call a referendum to decide the shape of the nation. So just a year and 3 months after independence, the first referendum was called for the creation of the Midwest. The Midwest was to be carved out of the old Western Nigeria. So on the 9th of August, this very month of August, is the 58th anniversary of the creation of the Midwest. The Midwest is the only area of Nigeria that was ever created constitutionally in Nigeria. The first three regions were created by fiat by the British. And after that, just before the Civil War in 1967, Gowon started the balkanization of Nigeria. So military men just started drawing lines all over the place. But the only time Nigerians sat down and wrote a constitution, our Republican constitution, where we were totally now estranged from the United Kingdom, was in 1963. And in 1963, Nigeria had four co-equal regions. Northern region in Kaduna, Western region in Ibadan, Midwest region in Benin, and the eastern region in Enugu. That was the status quo of Nigeria when on the 15th of January 1966, the military came and took over power. So we are saying that in terms of whoever is claiming marginalization today in the Nigerian nation,
yes,
they should realize that the most maligned, most marginalized, most reduced, most exploited, most explored is are the people of the Midwestern region of Nigeria, those 12 minority tribes. There are actually 12 tribes in the Midwest. Akoko Edo, Esan, Esako, Olam, Benin or Edo, Urubu, Enuani, which everybody calls Bende Igbo. Ika, Ukwani, Isoko, Western Ijo, or Western Izon, and Isekiri.
Just can you imagine? These are a bunch of lunatics that didn't cross. I don't know how these people even start. I don't know where they started. You are talking, you want to tell us where we belong. So, as an African origin, your name is Western Ejo. Western. The West, does West signify an African name in this sense? If you want to tell us their names, original names, we are going beyond all those things you people are mentioning. This is the difference between what is in the brain of this Ilei Ibinu and those of us that are agitating to restore our land way, way far back. This one he's talking now is the invasion of British. After the invasion of British, what is Western Ejo? What is Western? What is West? Western Ejo. So it doesn't have name. No.
We all of us have a commonality in the sense that we all say we came from the old. So let us put that way. That is the nexus of the old Benin Empire. And that area of Nigeria is the most exploited and most exploited. The whole of the South that we talk about today is an anomaly. It is a creation of Dr. Alex Ekweme in trying to dispel the silly constitution that was banded together by General Abacha. So he brought out the idea of dividing Nigeria into six geopolitical zones. Those geopolitical zones are unconstitutional. They don't exist in anywhere in our constitution. It's just in social space. But the only constitutionally created part of Nigeria, historically, is the present-day Edo and Delta states, which was then the Midwest, or Bengal. Bengal means Bini Delta, as I came about.
Okay, but you're not clamoring for
independence.
Yes.
No. But if it happens by default, so be it.
Please. We use your pen now and draw down this thing this man said now. I'm going to hang him. Just see the question now. See the question. And see the response. I'm going to hang him. You understand? You know, when we are listening, sometimes, this struggle have really opened most of our brain. When you are paying attention to somebody, you are trying to hold him responsible. And look at where he will kill himself now. Or ask him again.
So what even actually brought us out in the, particularly about 2.5 years ago, was when we started seeing our close neighbors. When I say I'm close neighbor, I mean our Yoruba brothers and our Benin Delta.
Yes.
As I came about.
Okay. But you're not clamoring for
independence.
Yes.
No. But if it happens by default, so be it.
So
what even actually brought us out in the, particularly about 2.5 years ago, was when we started seeing our close neighbors. When I say I'm close neighbor, I mean our Yoruba brothers and our Igbo brothers coming up with maps.
Okay.
And these maps were drawn without consultation with the people of the Midwest. And our first reaction was, this was what they did in 1967. Let me tell you what they did in 1967. When in May 1967, on the 27th of May, Mr. Gowon, Lieutenant Colonel Jacob Jack Gowon, who later became Yakub Gowon, decided to create wahala in the eastern region because of the failure of the Aburi Conference. He decided to divide the eastern region into three states. He turned the old eastern region into East Central State, which is now that East Central State now is now the five states of Ebonyi, Anambra, Imo, Enugu, and Abia. And then he created river states in Port Harcourt, putting the Ikoyi speaking and the Kalabari people. And then he created Southeastern State. So where is the Southeast today? Where is the Southeast geopolitical zone? Actually, he's referring to a state that is not even in that place. The Southeastern State was created in 1967 with headquarters in Calabar, which is now the combined Cross River and Akwa Ibom. So he now created, in the Western region, he just created two states, Lagos and Western Nigeria.
Yes.
So that was when the break started. And they started creating states, as if states were something you shuffled on a pile of cards.
So your concern is this.
Yes.
Paraventure.
Yes.
Nigeria.
Yes. Since it exists as it presently is constituted. Yes.
You want it's like the Edo Delta to be carved out.
Yes.
So you don't want to fall under the.
We are not Biafra.
The West.
We are not a Biafra. No. We are a unique people who, from 1967, in a universal referendum. That's why I support the Igbo clamor for a referendum. A referendum is that the people vote to decide how to want to federate. Nigeria is the...
Ile Ibina, I hope you are hearing your brother speaking. Your brother, you refer as they are all and all. He's telling you people that we have every right to agitate for self-determination. I hope you are hearing it. And your brother is also saying they don't belong to Yoruba and they don't belong to Biafra. The question now is, what are you people doing for your own? Everybody is now clamoring for their own house. Where do you belong to? What is the name? What is the name of the movement? Yoruba have rejected you. As well, we rejected you because as it thinks is happening, our brothers that is there will identify themselves. If you people don't want to obey the rules, we chase you all to Atlantic Ocean. Listen to hear, see, hear what this man will say about Biafrans. It's very, very, maybe these are the reason why they hate it. And I like it. I like it.
Most badly skilled federal structure in the history of the world. There is no federation like Nigeria. Nigeria is a badly skilled federation, and there must be a structural dismantling of Nigeria for it to be reconstituted along non-federal paradigms. It doesn't exist now. In 1967, August 18, the military of Biafra swept across the River Niger and went across the Midwest in a 24-hour blitzkrieg and took over Benin.
In Ile Ibini, 24 hours, our forefathers, it took them 24 hours to take over Benin. This time around, it will take 6 hours. The kind of men, the kind of men they are grooming now. Those days, our father, most of them still believe in all this, godly, Jesus Christ, religion, Father, help us, we are going to fight war. You are our defender, you are our protector. It take them 24 hours to take over that place because of sabotage. I am now relating this into what our brother said. It's out of this annoyance of you know, being a saboteur to our people. Or by commanding every other Benin people to don't have any Biafrans in your place. Maybe not even the military, the civilian that are running for their life. He took Biafran military 24 hours to take over Benin. Now it's 6 hours. Now it's 6 hours. Even 6 hours is even too much. I swear. You know, that is you, they are afraid you people are having. Because our people are waking up. We want to wake our people up. We want to wake their conscience up. We want to wake them up. These people are nobody. They are just good in killing themselves in the Western world. I will show you their videos here. Where they are fighting each other. Killing each other. In Italy. White people are the ones separating them. I have all of them. I have more than 20 videos of them. I prepared for them. I downloaded many of them today. If you see blood coming out, you ask what is going on. It's not the blood of white man or Indian or maybe another African country from somewhere. Edo versus Edo with the dagger. White people saw blood on everybody's on the run. Cultism. Aye, 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 aye. In Italy. Hear it again. On that, we overrun that place. 6 hours. I swear. That is your afraid. Our people must wake up. No, don't be afraid of what is it? You people should wake up. I'm telling you the fact. Now let's go. Let's go. Took them 24 hours. You are the one confessing. So that make you warn your people. And now some of the Igodo people have realized. In fact, it's 3 hours. Before I include the Igodo, it's 3 hours. 3 hours we overrun that place. 3 hours. Because these brave Igodo people, they are waking up to join the moving train. We give them a say. We must give them a say. We will give them opportunity to decide. We are not forcing anybody to join the struggle. This is the happiness I have. We are not, we don't conquer people. No. Conquer you for what now? That where we believe that everybody is equal before the God. I mean, before his fellow man, created by God. Oh, yeah, listen to your brother again. 24 hours, we overrun that area. Listen, our fathers.
May our soul rest in peace. Our fathers.
It doesn't exist now. Mm. In 1967, August 18th, the military of Biafra swept across the River Nile and went across the Midwest in a 24-hour blitzkrieg and took over Benin. And General Colonel Chukwuemeka Odumegwu Ojukwu announced the Republic of Benin. It was, there was a Republic of Benin before this one you have now in Tokyo, before the fall of Victor Obanjo in Oyo, and then the entrance of Mola Muhammad, who also came to the same Midwest to do havoc. So in Nigeria, the Nigerian Civil War was not fought anywhere. It was fought in the East and in the Midwest. We don't want that. We don't want to be collateral damage or cannon fodder for any contending ethnic.
Then tell your people to respect yourself. Tell your people to respect yourself, to mind their own business, to form their own country, to don't put eye in our own. We are not forcing anybody to follow us. We're only saying we want to give our brothers who are raising hand there that we should not leave them alone. They are with us. We will give them an opportunity. We just come and say, please, are you with us or not? Finish. If they say they are the same way, you think Biafra coming is just by force? Even the people of Biafra will also vote to decide whether they want Biafra or not. We don't force anybody. I don't know whether people don't understand the ethics of this struggle we are into. The Biafrans will also vote to decide, are we good with the Nigerian or do you want to have a new nation called Biafra? You think it's by force? Tell your people, tell them, make them know to block this locomotive that is on high speed before it will cross everybody.
Forces. We want to remain in Nigeria if Nigeria will restructure itself, because this Nigeria is dead. Let me be frank.
Please. Another point. I hope you people are taking this point. I am going to hang him in the next 4 minutes. You will see what he will say now. What did you hear now? Nigeria is what? Dead. Nigeria is dead. Repeat it again.
Ethnic forces. Repeat. We want to remain in Nigeria if Nigeria will restructure itself, because this Nigeria is dead. Let's be frank. Nigeria is not working. Anybody who thinks Nigeria is working is being economical with the truth.
Correct.
The only thing that has to be worked out is a palpable, acceptable paradigm that will put all the federating ethnic units in a place to negotiate their willingness to continue in the union or their unwillingness therefrom.
If the center, the federal government, agree to have talks, a roundtable discussion, and decided that we could restructure Nigeria in the palace of true federalism.
Yes.
Everyone, do you think IPOB will be willing?
You see, IPOB is that you don't legislate how your people want to be. So when I hear people put down IPOB, because I laugh at them.
I give you credit for that. I know when somebody speak good, I give him credit. I hope your brothers are listening. They are putting down on us. They are calling us internet freedom fighter, of which you yourself will also contradict yourself. Pay attention to this. He said what? Don't underrate them. You will see what he's going to say again about IPOB. These people talk with their both of their mouths. I don't know.
They are a very large chunk of Eastern. Ironically, I'm also Igbo in my way. I'm Igbo in the sense that I'm married to an Igbo woman.
Our brother, I will put my number here. It's not yet time to speak. I will put my number. That's how I do. I must receive call.
I speak Igbo. I have business in Igbo land. But I keep telling people that maybe the paradigm of division has not been taught out end to end by those who are propagating IPOB for three major reasons. Number one, everything about politics is economics, and everything about economics is politics.
Yes.
You cannot, the reason Nigeria is together today as a country, because Nigeria is not a nation, a nation is a state of mind, is as a result of the Igbo-ness of the Igbo man.
Correct.
The Igbo man is the little allies, the glue that puts Nigeria together.
You are correct. I hope the useless and the flavorful Igbos speaking Biafra, I hope you are paying attention. You are the problem. That is why we've never gotten our freedom. Because all these useless Biafrans who build houses in Lagos, in Abuja, in the north, they've thought about how to lose these things. That is why they are against this struggle. No any other thing. Nothing. They have no any reason. When they remember the investment, and they will start saying, no, it's better, let us remain one Nigeria. Very selfish people. You see this rain. Okay, you go fall. All of us will partake.
And because they are the only set of persons within that space that will leave his house in Imudo Chikeduru or somewhere in Aba and go to Karanamuda.
You are right.
And build a house.
You are right.
And build this business.
And invest.
And invest there. Okay. So the Igbo man is the highest commercial economic propeller.
You are correct.
Of the Nigerian state.
Okay, I'll come back to that. We have a caller. Hello, Luka.
The other time that I listened to him, he was talking about Ruga. And nowadays, Pedro, can you hear me? And you are giving us history of Nigeria. Up to now, can you now see what is going on in Nigeria about Ruga? You see, Pedro, you are a very clever man, which I love you so much. And I want to use that energy into things that will work positively in Nigeria. You are not talking about issue now, about the iPod and some other issues that they are doing. Yes, you need to come out to tell people, including the leaders of iPod, that you know better than what they are doing.
Now they can't hear walking. Any media, anywhere there, anybody sitting down that is not for this talk must mention him. Did you hear Owazirike? Name here. Did you hear this Ben Wabezlem? Did you hear any name? No. You the leader of IPOB, and who is he? Nnamdi Kanu. The man is walking.
Our father. Let me use the word. Our father. Your father.
Yinka. Okay, Yinka, please. Maybe when you want to make that phone call again, you should move away from your lovely daughter. She also wants to be part of the program. But,
I think Yinka lost the trend of thought. Yinka. I am proud to say that I brought the dangers of Ruga to the public domain. And I still say today that Ruga, which in Hausa means pursue, chase, Ruga means to pursue, in Hausa, Ruganka means pursue. And I made it clear that the people of Edo and Delta, I always speak on behalf of the movement of which I am the President General and Convener, which is the Midwest peoples. The question of IPOB, I'm not in IPOB, I'm not an Igbo man. But everybody has the right to clamor for whatever they want to clamor for. And I made it clear, we are interested in a united federal Nigeria.
Have you heard it now? This man that just said it some minutes ago that Nigeria is dead. I don't know where you come from. Do you revive dead person? Where you that is watching me? Where you come from? Did you revive dead, something that is dead? He's not interested. In a dead something, in a dead person. He's interested to see that the dead person will wake up again and then become normal. You see the problem these people have? They are like scrotum, jumping from one place to another. This thing he said, I never reach. Maybe you say, okay, this is interview, you had interview last yesterday, and have another one, maybe say tomorrow and contradict himself. In the same interview, he's saying Nigeria is dead. That anybody that is thinking about Nigeria, that person is just dreaming. He's now interested in a revived Nigeria. Nigeria. In fact, I don't agree that it's Igbo that is holding Nigeria. These are the people that are holding us. These people like this. This is the man that says Nigeria is dead. Now we are interested in a revived Nigeria.
Midwest peoples. The question of IPOB, I'm not in IPOB. I'm not an Igbo man. But everybody has the right to clamor for whatever they want to clamor for. And I made it clear, we are interested in a united federal Nigeria.
Oh.
We are interested in lifting the Nigerianness above the ethnic divides because we are the glue. And it is, we are the heartbeat and the beat of the Nigerian nation.
Hey, God have mercy. Before it was Igbo people is the glue. Now they are the glue. make na no allow grammar put you in a trouble. Common sense is not common. Common sense is not common. Let him round up. I give him 1 minute now. He's talking jargon. They are not the glue,
And you cannot transverse from the north, from the west to the east, from the south to the north of Nigeria without passing the territory of Edo and Delta. And I'm saying that in the marginalization history of the peoples of Nigeria, we are the most marginalized.
Maybe
you don't know your arithmetic and the history of the historiology of Nigeria. The northern region, of which was 1/4, today there are 19 states. The eastern region, which was 1/4, today there are 9 states. That is the 5 states of core Indigbo, plus the four states of Bayelsa, Akwa Ibom, Cross River, and Rivers. Don't forget that the deputy president of Biafra during the time of Ojukwu was actually General Philip Effiong from Ikota Abasi in the Akwa Ibom state. And the east and the west is now six states, but we are just two. But we are not fighting to be a new nation. But
why? Are you not a fool? You have been marginalized. Other zones have created so many states, and you know that in Nigerian system, it is based on number of states you have will, you know, give you the allocation. And you people keep quiet. Since 1960 something, it's only two states as you claim, and you are comfortable with it. And you see people that have been created many states and still fighting to destroy this Nigeria. And you people are saying no. Don't you think that something is wrong with you people? You said it now, you have been marginalized. Since the creation of Nigeria is only two states, and up to now is what people are having as you are claiming. And yet, you do nothing. Then if you see people that are doing something, you people will become against them. I know why I played this thing, because they post it in their forum and they are saying they think the man is making sense. No.
Nothing stops us, we are better. But we are saying that if the present president and his government cannot be brave enough to face the problems of Nigeria head on and square faced,
yeah,
and begin to restructure Nigeria. Nigeria is a unitary system of government that has federalism written only on the front page of a badly skewed constitution, which we did not write. The first page of the Nigerian constitution is a lie. And the first lie is we the people. But we the people never congregated to write that constitution.
Okay.
The last constitution we actually sat as we the people,
yes,
was 1963. We are saying Nigeria should go back there. We have a very clear-cut direction of...
Okay, now in closing, I don't want to continue this. Maybe you people must have seen it before. Let me leave this man to go. He's going back, you know, to 1963. We are going back to even 12 centuries, when white people have never come, is when we are going back to know ourselves. They are just going back to just yesterday, 1963. We are talking about 15-something, 14-something, that white men have never set foot in our land. This is to tell you, I know far. In fact, somebody going from Onitsha to Lagos, we have reached Lagos. India cannot go to our head bridge. These are where they are still talking about to go and revive something of 1963 after the invasion of white men, and we are going beyond that. So this is I don't want to finish it all, because he said a lot of things. Even he insulted IPOB and them, but everybody have a right to, I will not say insult, he say his mind. Maybe in our own eyes he's freedom of speech. We are not like Oba that keep people that speak. And most people are telling me that they are happy because Oba naked a man, that your father, just take your father's example now. You are talking here, they naked your father. Make a video in the market square, and you are saying that what they did to him is good, that Oba is after God, you get Oba. Then I told the guy that, in fact, after Namdekan, you get God, is what I told the guy. When he said to me, you don't know, he, in our place, he's after God, you got over. See, after Namdekan, you get God. To tell you that you people should resist from insulting that man anyhow, so that we respect each other. Oba, I am, what is fit? This call you are going to call me today. I want anybody calling me, if you are from that part of region, whether Asan or maybe Abo or whoever, you tell me the achievement of Oba. This is what I'm interested. I want to know what that man has, what dividends of democracy, what has he done in the life of those people that are killing their own fellow brothers to protect. Because the thing is, I am thinking, which kind of people is this? They have been giving us problem. They have been giving us problem. Namdi Kanu and his brokers, they will invade him. I have played you, though that I don't want to repeat it, but I wanted to play it today. The guy that said from Edo, you know, interacting with our leader inside in Macau, in the town hall meeting. They always come with passport. Which passport are you using? Which passport? This is their own argument. Passport. They will ask you, you are clamoring for Biafra. Which passport are you using? That's all. That's what they know. No any other proof. Nothing. Now, let me go straight to the point to show you what they do in Western world. That's what they do in Western world, and that is why I said we are. This is not we, man. No, 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 no. These people must have come from somewhere. This is not people of my origin. God forbid, Batin. No, no, no. They cannot. No, I can never. It's a lie. It's very, very. And now, pay attention to another scholar. This is what I'm playing you. What you are going to. The voice you are hearing today is their scholars. This is one of their scholars.
Answer this question that mostly comes from.
This is their scholars. And they are posting this in their forum. And if you see sharing, they are writing, you know, commenting. Wow, wow. Later, iPod, post it to the iPods. Post it to the slaves of Nnamdi Kanu. You are calling us slaves of Nnamdi Kanu. What, you are the original slave of Oba? Look at the another guy speaking. They take, look at him here. Look at the idiot.
My name is Aigbe Ewodari Okosun, the convener of Great Benin Emancipation.
Oh, yeah.
I want to answer this question.
Yes.
That mostly comes from people who are agitating for Oduduwa Republic and those agitating for Biafra. If Nigeria eventually divide today, where would Benin be?
Okay.
This question is thrown to us by reason of the Great Benin Emancipation standing out to reject the Biafra and those who now refer to themselves as Oduduwa Republic, sitting in their sitting rooms, and then draw maps that ends up in the territories.
Don't draw your own. Don't draw your own.
If Nigeria eventually divide today,
yes,
where will Benin be?
Yes.
Oh yes, Benin will remain where Benin has always been, thousands of years before Nigeria was formed upon Wazobia.
Okay.
And upon the agreement of those people majority was arrogated to, Nigeria was formed.
Okay.
Wa, Zo, and Bia.
Okay.
In other words, Yoruba, Hausa, and Igbos. These are people who did not resist the British colonialism. The Benin resisted the British colonization that led to the invasion of Benin by the...
Okay, my brother, I will play it because of you. Somebody's demanding. I will play it. I will play it. My David, I will do it. I will do it. It's okay. It's very important too, for those that have never heard it.
British, when you hear them say Nigeria is by forced marriage, regard it as force.
Can you imagine? Can you imagine? Can you just imagine? Can you imagine what one of their scholars saying? That if anybody tell you that Nigeria is formed by force, that is a lie. Hi, God of mercy. These people don't study. You people think I am general. These people don't go to, they don't study. Many of them, 99% of them in abroad are doing cultism. You people think I'm lying. Can you just imagine somebody telling us that Nigeria wasn't formed by force? Now, wow. Hi, God.
The name cannot be found in a company you name
No.
Nigeria by the British. When you hear them say Nigeria is by forced marriage, regard it as force, because your name cannot be found in a company you never agreed to be part of. The Nigerian marriage was conducted and formed upon Wazobia. Apart from the Benin sovereign nation, which had an embassy in Portugal at about 1555.
Hold on there, idiot. So Benin have an embassy in 15, which embassy in Portugal in 1555, big colony? Where? So in 1555, I have an embassy na Portugal. That's an embassy, maybe let's see that time na Portugal. You know why I posted this thing, eh? You know why I posted this thing? I didn't just post it because it is in their forum. If you see people that are clapping, they are more than 2,000. Telling this guy that, wow. Where are you? You are spoken well. The embassy of Benin is in Portugal in 1555. Wazobia, the idiot doesn't know that is a language. Try to see whether they will use it to unite us together. What? In Yoruba language. I think, which is come. Zo, Hausa, Bia. Which is in Igbo. Igbo is Bia. Bia means come. Wa, come. Zo, come. Because you people are able, you people don't belong anywhere. I say you people are bad. You are not for up. You are not down. That is why your language is not accommodated. And that's why we told you that a lot of shit has been done in the past. We need to destroy that place and begin to come together and say, what do we want? Form your own. We are forming our own. Or do they are going their own? Where are you? Nowhere. 1555. They need to. I'm telling you, my brother. Say it again so that I will remove you here. Because I cannot accommodate such lie that a Benin have embassy in Portugal in 1555. I will call C. Ronaldo and ask him. I will call C. Ronaldo. Anything. You see how to brush mouth in the morning with this kind of message, and I pay it out for those that speak Igbo. I need to go and find where something and start cleaning my teeth. Repeat it again. Let our people see it. 1555. You know, embassy.
To be part of. The Nigerian marriage was conducted and formed upon Wazobia. Apart from the Benin sovereign nation, which had an embassy in Portugal at about 1555,
oh,
there was no other nation on ground in that part of the world.
It's okay. Oh, one of their scholars. I want to. When you get your hand now, you are playing Nishi Barawa. You are home, Biafra, you are attack. We are resisted before you people. We have embassy in Portugal, 1555. Do you know when? What is 1555? They didn't know that they hear from one idiot that selling pepper in the street of Italy. How? God of mercy. Chineke Kebino. Can take all of us. Let us all of us go down. We don't fit to live. These are the people that need a consultation. Chineke Mekwere Mebere. 004 Nyefe. 1555. You don't even know what is Wazobia. Nigeria was formed under Wazobia. Oh. Okay. No chance, let us hear you. In fact, let me use no chance to calm myself down. Let me use that to calm myself. Let us use no chance to calm ourselves down because this thing I hear now, heat. No chance, what, in fact, tell us what is the problem with this man. Tell us. Look at him there. No chance, you tell us about this. Oh, yeah. Roach, Ungwa.
Mine,
Now I believe this one now. If because of this guy, I believe. Okay, my mother in a zoo, she that in a goof. Which kind of people do we have in this land? It is better for you to be stealing than to smoking goof. Oh no. This is where we are. Okay. Those that are just joining me for the first time, I'm gonna play you a clip about is a refreshment for those that let's refresh our brain. I know I've played it here before. I don't want it to be boring, but I know where I'm going to. We are still on the issue of Ile Ibini people. The line is also open in the next few minutes for them to call and tell me what I've said here now that is bad, you know, and that is not correct. I'm going to play you interruption of our leader in Macau. Our brother said he's never heard it. I think he's just gonna take us maybe 5 minutes, you know, to tell you that these people pursue us everywhere. Meeting of Biafran in Macau, they went. Everywhere we go, they find us. In stadium, they find us. Where we are doing meeting, they will come. You know? So, you people don't understand what we are still in court with them here. We are in the court. Can you imagine we are with them in the court here? You know? So that you people will know where I am heading. Most of people don't know. Let me play you the clip. Our brother demanded for it. I will do that. It's very necessary that I do it. So that, I think it's this. Is it this one? Good. That is it. I don't want it to last.
Architecture student here in Macau. And before I came here today, I've actually listened a lot. I've watched a lot of videos by Mr. Khan. And I admire him for his...
Our brother, they say he's looking for the date. The date was... Wait, let me give you the date. Oh, he's here, he's here. The date is... The date is 18th September 2015. 18th September 2015 in Macau. Oh yeah, roll.
His courage and all he has been doing. But as he has been speaking so far, as a student that I am, I've been taking notes.
Student.
And I have some very interesting questions to ask and some things to say and some corrections to make.
Correction.
All right. I'll begin from the very first thing he said when he stood up.
If you forgive me for 1 second, you're going to say that. We want to go live to the whole world because they're waiting so that they too can also participate. So just try and bear with me, please. We are arming the system. Say where you are, please. We are arming the system. This is Radio Biafra. For those who are just joining us, we have commenced our town hall meeting here in Macau, and we welcome each and every one of you. As always, our lines will open up later on, and you'll be able to field your questions. People are here gathered, and one of them is now on his feet. We'll ask him again to reintroduce himself, tell us his full name, where he comes from, and then put his question to us. I have just written my speech, and people are giving us off, course, questioning us as a result of that. Please, once again, please, your name and where you come from.
Thank you. I said, my name is Victory. I'm from Edo State, and I'm an architecture student here. I want to ask some questions, and I have some few things to say. Now, Mr. Khan started by saying that Africa today is poor because Biafra does not exist. Brothers and sisters, I was in Nigeria 2 weeks ago and I wept.
Okay.
I wept when I entered Lagos because the situation of that country is catastrophic.
Thank you.
But let's be honest with ourselves. Let's ask ourselves one question. Is it division or is it unity that will bring us together? In Africa today, there are countries that are suffering. Can you name one country that has survived out of division? South Sudan today, 5 years ago, they broke out. Yeah. But the country is in serious struggle. He started by saying that Africa is poor because Biafra does not exist. But seriously, brothers and sisters, I do not believe in that. Now, Africa is poor because of supremacy, because of Western imperialism. That is what we should tackle. Brothers and sisters, let us see ourselves as brothers. I'm saying this right now because I'm in Nigerian and I feel what this man is doing here today is treason.
Number one, he called him, he's committing treason. Number one insult, but no interrogation, no interruption. He was allowed to speak. That is who we are. If it is Obana that is I'm referring to that is causing treason, maybe stool will be coming from somewhere. You will see people fighting for Obana. Now everybody will come. He is continuing. He said he's causing treason. Continue.
Secondly, he said Asia became rich, most of the countries here became rich because of Japan. I'll tell you one thing. China, you're a China brother right now. China has a population of 1.4 billion and it didn't start by one day. You know, China actually was a country of different factions. They had warlords and people had, you know, different ethnicities. They were ruled before by people called the Manchus. All right, but today the majority of Chinese are Hans, but they all live, they work in unity, and China is a prosperous country in the world today. Also, he spoke about slave trade, how people came and took our people out and used them as slaves. Now, the real problem you have in mind, the real problem in the world today is the British. That is the problem. The white man is the black man's problem. Those are the people we should face. Africa has to unite, not just Nigeria, not Biafra. The entire Africa has to unite, and we need to know the problem. If we begin to create artificial borders today, borders that are not meant to be there, problem will continue. You speak about Biafra. I'm a Benin person, and I want to tell you, I don't know if you guys know about this, but have you heard about the Benin Empire? I will speak about the Benin Empire. If he knows probably about the Benin Empire. The Benin Empire actually, back in those days, was an empire that had a vast land area. Oh, yeah. But what happened? The British came and they broke it down. I'll tell you one thing. In the Benin Empire, in 1897, the British came. When they came, what they wanted to do is give the Benin massacre. Now, I'll ask everybody one question here today. In Nigeria, which country or which empire or which group of people, what ethnicity of Nigeria? None apart from the Benin Empire. Now, it was after the Benin Empire was conquered, that was when the northern and the southern protectorate of Nigeria was amalgamated. So, brothers and sisters, what is the purpose of saying all this? It is because as human beings, we must think with our common sense. It is very important as black men are sitting down here, we will not be brainwashed by anybody. I admire people trying to gain freedom, but what do we gain freedom for? We need to gain freedom from white supremacy. We need to gain freedom from imperialism. We need to love ourselves. We are above hatred. Now, Mr. Kanu, over time, has spoken about how he's getting help from countries like Israel and some other countries like that. Now, during the civil war in Nigeria, these are countries that helped us. But Israel as a country today remains one of the most racist countries against blacks. And we sit here and we listen to this man bringing and preaching words that will divide us. I'm ashamed. I'm really, really, really ashamed. He spoke about something else. He said, the Biafran radio today is more popular than BBC. That's a very huge lie. BBC has over 300 million users. That's bigger, that's larger than the population of the entire Nigeria. There is no way that I will accept that this radio is more than BBC. That is not the point of coming here. There are more important things for us to talk about. Now, the problem, the serious problem we are having in Nigeria is not our ethnic diversity. Hold on a minute, bro. It's not ethnic diversity. That is a blessing for us. It is unity that we need. We cannot continue to divide ourselves. We are one race. We need to see ourselves as one. There is no need. I'm fully aware. I'm not stupid. I'm a student. I'm fully aware of the atrocities that were committed during the World War. I know how many Biafrans died. But think about it, brothers. Do we want most of those people to die again in Nigeria? I'm not speaking out of fear. Okay? And I want to ask Mr. Kanu one question today. He keeps calling Nigeria a zoo. I want to say something. Nigeria is not a zoo. And if you are here today, you travel to Macau, I believe you use a passport to come to this place. And if you are holding a Nigerian passport and you call Nigeria a zoo, that makes you an animal.
Number two, he have called him an animal. No, did he hear any voice raising up? Any interrogation? Any interruption? The answer is no. If it is Oba, you call animal. Even by now, only care one of your head in one corner. One hand on the other end. Because we allow ourselves, those timid, cowardly Biafrans allow themselves to be intimidated by these junks. He called him an animal. Somebody we pay allegiance to, respect to the call. He called animal. Direct. But no, nothing. I didn't hear him say, hey, stop there. He calm. He was calm. Let him continue.
I'll say something else. He called, he said, he's speaking totally about Hausa men. Don't you think this man is preaching hatred within us? We know Nigeria has a lot of problems, but separating this country, is that the solution? Let us ask ourselves that question. Let's be honest. Is breaking down Nigeria the solution to the problem right now? We know Biafra wants to be free, but free from what? Free from what? Africa is being misled today, being looted. Central African Republic is not settled. South Sudan is not settled. Somalia, look at Eritrea. People are looting us, and those are the white men. And we come here and we still talk about dividing ourselves. Is that possible? No, that's not possible. They took people from our land and took them to America. What we should be doing today is building ourselves and inviting those people back home and let them come back home. Now, the Igbo people today in Nigeria, you guys are very, very familiar with somebody called Mrs. Okonjo-Iweala. This is a woman who was the finance minister of Nigeria. And all through her time in that position, I won't say she made positive impact in Nigeria. No, she didn't. He complained about Buhari not... I'm not a support of ethnic bias against anybody. He complained about Buhari not calling, what's it called, ministers and all that. We all know the problem. Because Nigeria is being ruled by a bunch of corrupt people. I don't care if it's Hausa man. A Benin man should be able to come out tomorrow and say that he wants to be the president of Nigeria. Just like Obama came out from Hawaii and became the president of the United States. We cannot continue like this. We need to be very, very honest with ourselves. I'm bleeding within when I heard this man saying some things. This is not the right way, brothers and sisters. This, what we are doing today is totally, bluntly, and extremely wrong. What we should be doing is how to change Nigeria. What we should be doing is how to change Africa as a whole. How to come together and unite. Even Bob Marley himself spoke about how Africa should unite. These are people that we should aspire again. To listen to Louis Farrakhan of the United States. He speaks about how Africa should unite. And we come here, still want to create artificial borders in Africa. It makes no sense. It makes no sense. He said that, okay, the Igbo believe in fairness and in justice. But what I've heard this man say so far, he's been biased. What I've heard this man say so far, he has vested interest in him. All the interest he's talking about is based on the fact that he wants the Igbo people to rule Nigeria. I don't have any problem with that. Fine, I know you guys want your freedom, but bros, this is not the... Just give me a moment. This is not the issue right now. I'm not saying Igbo people should not rule or they shouldn't have their sovereignty or whatever. But Nigeria is a country that has different ethnicities. And what if everybody begins to stand up as a Benin person? What if I say we want independence?
Yes.
As a Yoruba man, if he comes out and decides to speak that, oh, I want independence, will Nigeria be settled? Let us think. I want to ask us this question. If Mr. Kanu can tell me about one country in the world that has been what they are today based on the fact that they broke up, that they are doing really well today, and I will be very, very delighted, especially in Africa. So, brothers and sisters, let us use our common sense. We must use our common sense. This man is brainwashing us, and if I dare him to bring out his passport right now, if he can't bring out his passport right now and show it to all of us, then we confirm his nationality. If he's Nigerian, then we see that passport. I'm ready to burn my passport for this man. And everybody here, if you are willing, burn your Nigerian passport and let's go to Nigeria. Excuse me. He should not be here. Excuse me, please. Mr. Francis, please.
They tell him to round up. A minute. They have given him a minute since and he's still speaking. They are telling him to round up.
Mr. Francis, listen, I respect everyone here, okay? I have so much respect for you. I've traveled a lot in these countries here in Asia, and I know what we pass through as Nigerians. But believe me, segregation, either ethnic, racial, whatever it is, will not help us. We need to come together. If the Igbo people want people to look towards them, then Mr. Kanu should go to his state and model his state, develop your state, and let other people look forward to your state. And we can vote for you as the president of Nigeria. So you've made ill references. You've spoken about how...
Can I address some of the questions you're raising?
I want to address what you're saying.
If I, Oba is... I'm talking now. Oba say I should give him the microphone. That he gave me. I say, wait, when I'm done, my microphone, I gave you to speak. You see how he was calm. All those while he was speaking, Nnamdi Kanu was there just coming down, making notes and watching. And the moment he said, can I respond to most of the things, he started shouting, when I'm done. You see how arrogant these people are. We will chase him to Atlantic Ocean. You treat him with a joke. Let him finish.
Listen to me. Okay, fine. You guys may be agitated about everything I've said.
No, I'm going to respond to you. What am I doing?
Listen, but if as a human being, even if as a black man, we continue like this, we will never, ever, I swear with my life today, if as black men we fail to see the fact that we need to unite, irrespective of our ethnicity, we will not go anywhere. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you.
I welcome. The reason why I allowed him to speak is because I want to address. I think this is the very first time encountering this.
Ayama.
And I want to start from the beginning.
Correct.
You said that imperialism is the problem, is that correct?
Yes.
Is that what you said, yes or no?
Absolutely.
And that the British is the problem. Did Britain practice imperialism in Africa or not?
It is.
Are they part of the problem?
They are the major cause of the problem.
They are the major cause of the problem. Who created Nigeria?
Nigeria.
Yes.
British.
The British.
Yeah.
So if Britain, can you? I want the world to hear him, please. Come, because the world, come, give him the microphone, please.
Yeah,
so that people can hear his response on.
Make an try study. anything you don't know, if you know nothing about any topic, don't go ask to debate. You see, all this, what do they call it? This is the rabble rousing that they call it. All this, only two sentences have destroyed what he just said now. Imperialism is the problem. He asked him, you believe that it's British that is causing the problem? He said, yes. And you believe that the problem of Nigeria, you say yes. Then who created Nigeria you are trying to harbor? Is the British. Then why are you harboring it? The same way that is people are harboring Harcourt, Port Harcourt, a white man created.
In the radio, because the whole world is listening, please. Because the sometimes in life is that the reason why I don't debate with people from New Zealand because they don't come. I want us to learn from each other.
Sir, please. No, I would like to warn you. We have problems if you keep calling us a zoo. I don't.
You see, he's telling him we will have problem. No, assuming that I meet you up and challenge you up that you have a problem, I will give you problem. How will you feel? I'm asking you, Lebini people. No, I'm asking you. Just, I met you up and said you will have problem. If you repeat that thing again, you will have problem. How would you, I'm asking you, how will you feel? To tell you how arrogant people are, who will chase you people with Atlantic Ocean. And that is say with a joke. I'm happy that Igodomigodo people are rising up. Let me see people who back you up. Before it was 24 hours, now it's 3 hours. Suffocate everybody. It is a something where we don't roll into. This is just an organization compared to what is to come. We are beating up. We are beating up small. We are waking our people up from those that are suffering from religious disease. They wake up to know that religion don't help anybody. Even God we are calling don't help anybody. God help those who are helping themselves with your faith that you are putting their work on practice before you get your help from somewhere. People are beginning to wake up. People are smiling and waking up and say, yes, this thing have never helped anybody. Rather, it's a sign of death. This thing you are doing like this. People are waking up. Before it was 24 hours. This time around, 3 hours to chase you people to Atlantic. Either you enter boat and go back to where you come from, or you mellow down. We mellow down. We, in our place, we tell you how you live. We are not chasing anybody. But if you don't want to live according to rules and regulation, all move.
I don't know what this man is talking about. You should address people as mature adults. Don't come here and start calling Nigeria a zoo. It makes no sense. It doesn't make you have the spirit of leadership. No, I'm getting agitated. I don't like what he's saying.
That's what I'm saying.
He should stop calling Nigeria a zoo. I'm not saying this because of my own interest.
Hey! We are not here to argue.
You see, that is the problem. You see,
No.
The people don't understand.
Since he doesn't want to.
We are live on the air.
Are you doing this?
Listen to me.
Do you want to stay here or not?
Listen to me.
Do you want to stay here or not?
This meeting is for indigenous people of Biafra.
Correct.
Do you want to stay here or not?
So for your brother, that is why you are.
Listen to me.
No. I'm not offending you.
No.
I think that is about time that he leaves because he doesn't want to.
Let him go out now. I don't know why the British cannot be.
They don't debate. But that's the world is listening.
They don't debate.
He's a typical.
No, he should ask the right way. He should not call us.
My goodness, man.
Oh, Nigeria, a zoo. He should ask the right. This is treason, man. He should talk the right thing. Say the right thing, man. Bro, I have so much respect for you.
Listen to me. I don't want to send you out.
You can't send me out.
I will send you out.
You can't.
No.
I'm not gonna send the air out. I'm not going airborne. You hear that? You can't send me. I'm not gonna send the choir out. I'm not going ababa alo. You can't. I'm not gonna quaffle the idiot out. What he asks is everybody have his own opinion, but why not calm down so that he cannot because you are talking and change his way or modus of operation. Nigeria is still a zoo. From what is going on now, can't you see that he's even animal supposed to be dragging us to court? If I know the chairman of animals, the animal kingdom, they're supposed to drag us to court for calling Nigeria a zoo because it's an insult to them. We will find a name below zoo. I have called it dilapidated mortuary, but dead body have also respect more than what is existing now. We need to find anybody. Somebody should find a name that's stable so that we will tell our leader, stop calling these people. He said, we're elevating them. Animal here, if you see how animal here behave, when it is red, they are going, it is red traffic, they will stop. They will be looking. They are in front of their own now. Nobody is holding them. The watch is green. They cross road. You are comparing these people with such behavior. No.
I will demolish the garbage you came up with line by line. I went to school, and I want to prove it to you that I am educated now. Line by line, the construction of the garbage you came up with. You said that Britain is the problem, British imperialism is the problem. Who created Nigeria? Britain created Nigeria, and if Britain is the problem, anything they created is also a problem. Simple common sense that demolishes the garbage you come up with. That's number one. You mentioned artificial borders. Who created artificial borders? Is it not the white man?
Yes.
Is it not the white man? You are telling me that having the zoo called Nigeria is a homogeneous society? Do we speak the same language?
No.
Do we speak the same food?
No.
Do we have the same religion?
No.
When was the zoo created?
1914.
Market
Square.
Is that very clear or not? In 1914, it is a zoological republic. It's a zoo. That's what it is. It's a zoo. Complete animal. See the way they behave like wild animals. A complete animal. You can see the way they behave. The world is listening to them. That is how they are. Baboons and monkeys. They are. I want to demolish his petty, childish argument. That is the way they are. They call Radio Biafra and they rant. It's a good thing I have them here today. So I can demolish their nonsensical argument. Can we please proceed? He was ranked as a baboon. Maybe Buhari can give him some change. Maybe pay his school fees. He's very hungry and he's very poor. The zoo is a zoo. It's as simple as that. I will continue. He said that the world is listening, please. We are addressing the junk that he came up with. I want to demolish it. He said that it was only Benin people that fought the British.
Yes.
Maybe he has not heard of the Kumeku and the Asaba massacre.
No, no, we're in there.
That's why I say they don't go to school in the zoo. That's why I call them baboons and monkeys. They're not learned people. They don't read. The Kumeku, go and ask for that name and they will tell you. We fought the British every inch of the way. That is why they hate us.
Yes, yes.
He also said he may have dealt with artificial borders. It was actually the so-called Nigeria that is founded on artificial border. I wanted to educate him. I don't know why he's running. I want to let this child understand that you have Yoruba in Benin Republic. Is that true or false?
True.
Who divided the Yoruba of Benin Republic and the Yoruba of the zoo? Who divided them?
British and French.
He is talking about that. You know, I want people that when next time I want those that went to school, not children who didn't read. It was actually your so-called Nigeria that introduced artificial boundaries in the first place.
Yes.
For your information, because you are not learned. They said that Radio Biafra is not more popular than the BBC. Is that true?
No.
Do we run TuneIn? Do we run it?
Yes.
Independent organization.
No.
We trended at number one before we went to our own app. By none. People who did not go to school. He said that the zoo is not a zoo. It is worse than a zoo.
And I tell you.
Nigeria is worse than a zoological republic. It is far more worse. He said that we preach hate. Is that what he said? He said I preach hate. Is that correct?
Yes.
Have you heard of what the Sadwana of Sokoto said? Yes. About Igbo people?
It's on YouTube.
It's on YouTube.
Yes.
Do you think this student in Macau has actually seen it?
No.
Is that not hatred?
Yes. Long time already, though.
Who said that they hate us first? Amosa Fulani said they hate Igbo people.
Amadi Bello said it.
Amadi Bello came out and said it before I was born. I hate Igbo people. These are the so-called Nigerians. You know, there's something called hypocrisy and lack of intellect. That is the bane of a black man in Africa. And allow me to repeat what I said. Without Biafra, Africa is doomed. Without Biafra. And there's something called inference, because I'm learned. You draw inference. If you went to school in the zoo, I can't help you, because I'm learned. The reason why Japan is key is because of this. The same thing happened in Europe. It is called competition, in case you don't know. You don't build an economy based on sentiment. You build it based on competition. Why don't all the casinos in Macau come together and be one happy big casino? Because you stifle human creativity and ingenuity if you remove competition.
I didn't tell you.
Oh my goodness me. Let me continue to demolish the frivolous and nonsensical argument. He mentioned Okonjo-Iweala did not do well. I wanted to ask him, can you name one Hausa Fulani or a dumb man that did well in the economy?
Oh yeah, can I come? Then they go to school.
That's a zero.
No, man.
Absolute zero.
As if you know that is what I'm asking. Not
because they don't understand the fundamentals of economics.
Where they go?
Because you cannot run a viable modern economy in the absence of competition, for goodness sake. What Biafra provides will be a compelling platform to allow people to freely engage with one another based on mutual respect, not on some frivolous sentimentality. Let me tell you this garbage about black. We are all black. We are from Africa. Who told you we are one people? Who told you we are one people? I ask you, do you have my DNA inside you? Do you eat my food that I eat? Do your mother tie two piece wrapper the way my mother does? What makes us the same people? I trace my ancestry and my lineage to the Holy Land of Israel. Where is yours? I don't know where these people went to school. I don't know. That is why they go to for strike for 3 years. And the fourth year they graduate. You don't go to the library to go and read.
Oh, God, is
it? Who brought hate into Nigeria? Did you know that and is not a single man? Who fought for Nigeria to be independent? Who is more Nigerian than Nnamdi Azikiwe? Did Yoruba vote for him? Did Hausa Fulani vote for him? Who is more, who peddled more hatred than Hausa Fulani? You don't go to YouTube to go and see things for yourself. You come here and you talk rubbish. You don't know who I am. You go to rule Nigeria. What utter garbage.
That's how
to rule people who drive cattle from place to place, you must be drunk. I want people who are civilized. People who understand what hard work means. Do I also work hard? Do you think that all these things you're seeing in China, everywhere in Southeast of Asia, it fell from heaven? Hard work. Hard work. You are telling me about people that separated and they became viable. I will give you one simple example for your information. The United States of America was a colony of the British. And for your information, everybody who is somebody in America claimed their ancestry from Mary Rose. Mary Rose sailed from Southampton in England. English people, George Washington is English by ancestry. He said no to feudalism. He said no to monarchy. Because they understood that the fundamental basis of human advancement is based on the quality of one man to the other. Correct. Not on having a king or a queen.
Is that here? Monarchy. All this in your hands, this monarchy. That's all. That's. Is, I think it's only... No, the thing tire me. Is them. Is this is what is disturbing them. This monarch. I think so. That is their problem. That's their problem. I remember. It's true.
I will give you one simple example.
This all about
information.
The problem. I know.
The United States of America was a colony of the British. And for your information, everybody who is somebody in America claimed their ancestry from Mary Rose. Mary Rose sailed from Southampton in England. English people, George Washington is English by ancestry. He said no to feudalism.
Correct.
He said no to monarchy.
Correct.
Because they understood that the fundamental basis of human advancement is based on the quality of one man to the other.
Correct.
Not on having a king or a queen. Do you understand that? Difference of value system, that is what tells you who you are. Value system, not color or race. Value system. Okay. If you believe in the same fundamentals as I do, you and I can be in the same country, no problem.
Correct.
Not where one people believes in rank ahead and other people are working very, very hard. After giving your summary or your summation, you failed to mention where the oil and gas comes from. You failed to mention how people are dying on the way to Europe. You failed to mention the slaughter of our people. You failed to mention the aggregation of every word that we have given to Europe. Before we came to liberate our people, let me remind you once again, we went to school to go and study. Very, very hard and very well.
We have graduated,
though.
God.
To arrest them, but to remember, they came up with this nonsense, Africa, let's unite garbage. They formed OAU. Is OAU working?
No.
Is OAU working?
No.
Their children are drowning on their way to Europe. Have they ever called a summit to discuss the plight of their children?
For where?
I am a student of contemporary politics and economics.
Correct.
What determines the people who should be together is their value system, what they believe in. That is why you have communism. That is why you had capitalism in those days. Different sets of values. That was the problem between Cuba and America. Different sets of values. That was the problem also between the East and the West until the Iron Curtain fell. It is called value system. If you find commonality in a value system, you can coalesce and can become one as a people.
Igodo, we are with you, people.
I welcome your critique. It is to let our people understand that we are prepared. I wrote everything you said down. I have torn it to pieces. What if you want you and I to be in a country together? You have to believe in what I believe in.
Correct.
I will give you a simple example. If you want to become a United States of America citizen, you pledge the oath. Is that not correct?
Correct.
Do you take the oath in America or not? Before they give you their passport, you must swear allegiance, isn't it? Oath of allegiance in America. You will swear to uphold the Constitution of the United States of America. Which means you can be Alakoba, you can be Islam, you can be Muslim, it doesn't matter. But you must swear to this to uphold that piece of document. Inside it says everybody has the right to free speech. Do you understand? Everybody is born equal before the law.
Correct.
Everybody can go to court to seek redress. They did not say Sharia court. They said court. Proper Judeo-Christian Greco-Roman court. Is that true or false?
Free speech.
You need to believe in democracy if you want to become an American. Is that true or false?
Correct. Correct.
It is called value system. If you don't like it, you prefer life in Saudi Arabia, where they read the Quran and cut off your hand or your leg if you want to, then you go there. The value system of Saudi Arabia is based on Sharia, the laws of the Quran. If you like it, you go and join them.
Correct. Correct.
Value system. The zoo has none.
At all, at all.
Why do we call it a zoo? Yesterday, a policeman shot dead a certain lady called Comfort.
Yes, I showed them last time, yes.
Do you know why Comfort was killed? The husband has keke napep with the children inside it. Do you know why she was killed? Do you know why she was killed? 50 naira.
Now, wow.
People are saying, why can't you make Nigeria work? It can work someday. I want to live in a country where the police people don't carry guns. You want to live in a country where they carry guns. You and I don't see eye to eye. Because before the white man came in my village, there was no police. Talkers of carrying a gun. Was there any stealing?
No.
Any criminality?
No.
Any war?
No
raping of women. This was before the white man came into our land. We had no police. The Tawasa, I respect them, they had their own police. Yoruba, the Hausa used to be called Alakali. Do you remember that Alakali in primary school? Alakali. I don't begrudge you. I'm not against what you're doing as a person. I am telling you, before the British came, there was no Nigeria. Simple and short. Nigeria was what created artificial boundaries. If I may ask you, Mr. African, what is the meaning of the word Nigeria? Is it an African name? Is Nigeria an African name? It means Niger. Niger means Niger. In French, Niger is a Latin word. In French, it is called Niger. It means black. That's the meaning of it. Even yesterday, one of your musicians, Niger Raw, changed his name to Mr. Raw. Why? Because in America, he went to Apple and said to Apple, I cannot sell my music. He's a Nigerian artist. A zoo artist, I should say. He said to them, why are you not selling my music? They said, you cannot answer this name here. He said, but this thing means Niger. Niger means Niger. Niger word. Well, that's what I answer. They said no. Here is an offensive word. Remove it. He changed only yesterday to Mr. Raw. Changed his name. Is the name Nigeria African? The answer is no. What is driving me mad is this. Who created Nigeria? Was Nigeria created by Africans? The answer is no. So what is, if the basis of your argument is that Britain, Europe, the white man is the problem, and you're trying to fight defending what the white man created, that means you're very foolish. You don't know your own argument then. You started very well and I supported you that imperialism is the problem, Britain is the problem, I agree. Then how come you are supporting something that Britain created not to serve your interest as a black person, but to serve their own imperialistic view of life? That is where your argument collapsed. I don't hate people. I don't dislike people, but anything that comes from that place is not worthy. There is this thinking and this saying, you know, our people, they put so much stock on passport. And I have said this thing before on Radio Biafra, and I will say it again. Which travel document do you think that George Washington was using when he fought the British in America? If Sorry, in case you don't know, the name George Washington is English. But he fought his own people saying, I don't want to live under a king. I believe that all men are born equal. That is George Washington's value system. It was at odds with that of King George in England. King George came to war. Americans fought and they beat the British. America became an independent country where men are born equal before God and before the laws of man. Different value system determines who you are. People from Edoko, Prodio Biafra, to say, include Edo in, if you were listening before as you claim you do. I said no. Why did I say no? Because you have a respected monarchy that I respect myself.
You see,
I like the institution of monarchy, the upper of Benin, I respect very much.
Did you hear it now? This man has said he respects him. But they are talking now here, now they can't insult our upper. To hell with him. Who is he? So we run because of Oba. Somebody that go to toilet, he eat, he go to toilet, he sleep, he bath, he even have sex with a human being. He drive, he drink water, he cry, he laugh. All these things I'm counting. I do it the same. So what is the difference? Because you pay allegiance to him, and you are causing this man that most of us take like God. And you're telling me Oba is like our God. So you can insult other people and go free. Then we'll be saying Oba talk well. Oba, you know, don't you know that I deserve to be saved? Methuselah talk well. You don't know. 3 hours as things is going now. I'm happy. Our brothers are waking up. Those who have been suffocating for years. I never knew because of this emergency of Biafra, they want to kill yourself. About this teaching this guy gave us 2 days ago. That's their friend. So if this thing Biafra come now, there will be emancipation of those that have been held under slavery. Don't you know that people are slaves in those states now? As I'm talking to you, some people are still living way far back in the centuries where slaves exist. People are still there now. You don't talk, you nothing. If somebody say, even if Oba collect your land, Oba top bell. Oba even maybe rape your wife. Oba top bell. Even oh yeah, go and naked this man. They naked you, bring you to the market square, take your video, Oba top bell. Triumph for my land. You can do it in you can. No. Make una calm down. Make una calm. Look at him, hear him. Said he paid respect to Oba. I don't know where they brought these concocted stories to fool others. You don't know we have the clip? You don't know we have the clip? Bring your own evidence where Namdekan is insulting Oba. I am showing you the evidence where he's respecting Oba. And you are, everybody is insulting this man. They think we keep quiet. Turn to hell to Oba. Oba Bakwok. You people will call me today and tell me what Oba has done in your life. And that's why I'm here today.
George Washington's value system. It was at odds with that of King George in England. King George came to war. Americans fought and they beat the British. America became an independent country.
Correct.
Where men are born equal before God and before the laws of man.
Correct.
Different value system determines who you are. People from Edoko, Prodio Biafra, to say, include Edo in, if you were listening before as you claim you do.
I played them yesterday. The lady called.
Why did I say no? Because you have a respected monarchy that I respect myself.
Hey.
I like the institution of monarchy.
Hey.
The upper of Benin, I respect very much.
Hey.
Institution, I do.
Chai.
If you bring them into Biafra, we are a republic. We will not have any Igbo, no Eze, no king. Everybody will be equal. Because we don't want to reduce or denigrate the institution, you can keep your Benin kingdom.
Chai.
All well and good, there is no problem. You want to go and get a Fulani man living in Sokoto to be in the same country with you. Okay, how about a Fulani brother who lives in the Niger Republic? Do we leave them out?
It's okay.
Now, who is breaking artificial boundaries? You talk about bringing people together. How about Hausa lives in Chad? How about Hausa in Ghana? Why don't we go for them as well? That is why before you come... They are, all of them are Christians, true or false?
It's okay. This is the really the side I want him to speak. He respect Oba. He respect the institution. But people are still calling. More calls are still coming, please. Most of them are here with us. Most of them are in our meeting. They contribute to our meeting. Now I begin to realize that they are not Bini. They are those that don't accept that slavery in Bini. And now begin to differentiate those that are joining us. Those that have been saying, Nnamdi Kanu, continue with what we are doing. I begin to see, you know, in this life, something must happen. You must show who you are. I never knew that there's something called Igodomi Igodo. Until I never knew. I was thinking is everybody's Bini. I don't know that Ile Bini people, those that are believing in the slavery of Oba. So those people are calling us, they want to join in what we are doing. Most of them are here. Most of them are here with us. And they are contributing. Most of them even use Biafra to take asylum. I know two in our forum use Biafra and they got positive. Now they have working permit here. And they are still coming to meeting. They are contributing. And they're saying they want this Biafra. One is telling us that even though he's from Edo, that he knew that as soon as Biafra come, that Nigeria at least, people will have a different fresh air. His concern is Nigeria, not any other thing. He just wants this Nigeria to go out so that people can see another life. We've never had something like that before in our life, but we have been so-called unity and progress, you know, compacted in their national anthem. Peace and unity. Is there any peace now? Is there any unity? We have had this thing before. Let us try another way. And you want us to continue reviving a dead person. Now, this is their job here. Look at their job. Look at what they do. Biafra France, make una wake up. The journey this time around will be a different ballgame. You know, you people should not be, don't be afraid. That thing they know, we know it. Aumbe, mbambang kroll, okay, how? Is it to use somebody as sacrifice? Is it? I have already sacrificed myself. Me. And I am already a sacrifice. They have used me as a sacrifice. What is in this earth now that we'll be afraid of? What is it? Now let me show you their job here. Let you see what they're doing here. I've showed you see how they are killing themselves in Europe. White people are the ones that are separating them. God forbid, Batten. God forbid. Let me show you them. That's what they do in Europe here. Fight to Aye, Aye, Bukania. Abobo. No. Hey, oh, no, I cannot wait. We need to start with these people. These Fulani self are not our problem, I swear. Fulani is never our problem. I've never seen any Fulani call before or start invading where we are doing meeting or come to stadium where we have flag or even see Yoruba doing all those things. People don't know who is our enemy and you are here chasing air. These people are our problem. There are few. We just feed them out, push them into Atlantic Ocean. Life continues. You know, let me show you what they are doing in Europe. This is their brother, Igodomigo. I think he's from Igodomigo, but he said they killed yourself. Look at him there. Let me zoom in so that they will see you. Look at what they do in Europe. Look at it here. Pay attention. That's what they want us to continue. Look at this is just you have seen it before. But those look at it here.
It's problem must always come to poor. What's make I come poor today? 4 days ago, yes. The one video that I made for social media, I couldn't talk to my people with my dialect, Eka Agbo language.
Okay, wow, okay, from Eka.
This one say I couldn't talk about Edo, Bini, some Bini people, some Edo people. They're going to say, choose, if you get in mind, come back on social media.
Have you seen that Edo people that I see their division there? You see, they even include this one. They include these people in their own kingdom. Kingdom backwalk.
Yeah, I repeat what you said in English. Because they fine, I'm not getting our time. About 3 people call me, they take my number for social media. Really? Because if I get my make, I repeat them. But I'm not getting to repeat them.
What do you talk? Make I talk them. What do you talk? Let me pin my number here. What do you talk? Where they say make you repeat them for English. What do you talk, Steph? Oh. Italy. Try and first try here. You sleep in jail for all the rest of your life. You threaten somebody in Austria? Are you mad? No, I love this country and I will respect their rules and regulations. I will keep it. I'll keep my number here. What can you talk what you just
said? All those people, because I must say, me and they don't get connection, me and they don't get business. But yesterday and today, something happened. Because okay, make I can't talk about this thing that happened. And at the same time, make I repeat what I talk 4 days ago, concerning what I tell my people with our dialect. I let them know, say, this social media is tough. And those people, believe people. They want to enter our body, because they make trouble with us. So
we are here with
people.
You.
No, say, make we not give them mouth, because nobody will be saying, as an Imbi Agbo person, a normal person, Agbo person will come up for social media, call the talk nonsense. Call the talk, say, me a prostitute. I don't use prostitution. Train my younger one for school. I use prostitution. Build house. I use prostitution. Do this, I do that. Now, what do you mean talk? And I let them know, say, make them not follow them, drag anything else.
Hey, then they come for social media, they tell us, say, they carry prostitution, build house. They are not ashamed of us. I repeat what I said before. You know, as I apologize, for me to marry gay people, I better become a gay. Ta, what I carry their woman, the women don't finish. I fuck good, they're mad. Talk.
Social media, well, that's by the way. What happened yesterday? They say one of our person be saying an Agbo person. He come, he say choose. I'm facing problem now. I say what happened?
Child.
By the way, not be him coming. I sister went to Germany. Now I come, he say brother, be help me. He get with him, my brother. He pass through for Italy. So waiting they happen.
Italy.
I go say okay. Give your brother my number. Make him call me. He come, my brother say Baba, what thing they happen? Kill him, man. He said one guy we come from Auchi we be Eye
threatening
now he go kill him. I go say
Eye for Italy. They threaten your fellow hell. Black people, you know when another guy is talking, you will be cursing him. Can you just imagine Eye Italy Eye? Just maybe you don't have, maybe as real Ciro Ronaldo is playing for Juventus now, somebody will be threatening him to kill him, that he's there. Yeah. Hey, God of mercy, God of mercy. I know, repeat, it's our here. Yeah.
One guy, we come from Auchi, we be here. Yeah, they threaten him, saying go kill him. I was okay, what him bring this issue? He said, wait for the hustle, you know, say. As in the popular house where there is eat low within our charity. Your turn, your
turn. I am making a see my face. Make I explain the charity for those that are from Nigeria. Charity, oh, beggars, wretched beggars. Baba Yala, those in house, those people that used to carry plates, they beg. These are what they are doing in Italy. He said it now. He said, this is what they do. They stand in front of supermarkets and be begging. God of mercy. These same people that are begging have carried their head. It said to for them to see Biafra come. Let them, it's better they rape their own mother. Shorotti in Italy. Begging. I saw them when I went there. I saw them. Child, I will still show you their video where they are begging. I have everything here today. So that let it not be as a propaganda. They beg on the street of Italy. Poor country. I went there. I said, wow. When I came back to this Austria. I say, I go to in front of this parliament, Austrian parliament. This time, this thing, you know, you put the dude over top, well. I do it. Parliament, top, well. Austrian parliament, top, well. No, cannot. This country, I will uphold your law. I will respect your law. You have been good to me since I was born. Nobody have offered me a job where I call my home. I have gotten so many invitations, job opportunities. I have gotten scholarships. You send me to Czech Republic to go and study. You pay my school fees. You pay my hostel fee. I came back. You give me 1,400 euro as congratulations for passing the results. I continue again without paying school fees. I studied here free of charge. I didn't pay 1 cent. On top of it, I am borrowing book from the library free of charge. Austria top. I owe allegiance to you. I owe respect. I can kill to protect your interests. I'm a black man, yes. But you are so good to me, more than where I come from. Until we restore our land, then I can begin to be proud of where I come from. But till now, here is my country. For now, Biafra must come. And we have swear with our life and blood to make sure that this country comes to reality. These people are frustrating us. And we are going to chase them away. This is the promise. I know you are in support of what we are doing. We chase them. They are suffocating the innocent souls. Look at them talking. Continue. Hey, yeah. You know, they do short.
What do you bring this issue? It's the way for the hustle. You know, say, as in the popular house where there is it within our charity. Yeah, Otano, on our understand charity.
We know.
Starting super, start for photo supermarkets and hustle. You know what I mean by
begging
for the supermarket and
hustle. No, be hustle begging.
You see, anytime we come hustle for supermarkets, one particular guy they call the warrior. He said, for this if you me and you did, it is either you kill me or I kill you. I go, so what's happened? What's happened with this guy? He said, no. See, the guy they call the threatening, I'm like steady.
Now, wow.
Say me an AM man. As if you say me an AM man from Auchi, I'm gonna make sure say I go pursue for this Italy. And be and surely one day I will stab you to death.
Now, wow.
Then I was like, all this way they talk. He don't take action once. He said, yes, he said before, now to come threaten and go. You know? But now, what did they do now? He say, if he come, he go grab him.
Now, wow.
He said, yesterday, yes, yesterday, which is on the 25th, which is 25th, in slapper.
Oh!
Because I said, this is not going to be careful. He said, he will carry stick to the platform. Where old man stand? Okay, make a shot at the picture. And I see the picture.
Child, can you imagine?
This is the picture of the man talking about where we say one guy they torment for Italy.
Child.
And this guy with the tormentor. If you see the guy's face, you know, say both of them will be mates at all for one day. But because he be earlier,
oh,
because they come, they threaten this guy, wait yeah, for the hustle. This guy let you know, say, Abobi, see how they be. Me not get program again. I never get documents. I carry one room from person. I they pay light bill. I they pay gas bill. I they pay water bill. I they pay house rent. As they be now, not only this shorty what they do now for the supermarket, but for the hustle, not that for the get money. Okay, now you now see the camp. They see the.
Aya, wait. The lay Benin people. Delay Benin person still day camp. When you hear camp, no be football camp. I am explaining this for those that are at home watching from home, because those in Western world know what is camp. Camp means refugee camp. You know here IDP camp. You see that IDP camp? Those displaced those people that Boko Haram displaced from Boronu. That place they are. This is where this person that is giving say his area is staying. It is called camp here, but here is a little bit modernized. They give them like 50 or every month, which is maybe say 25,000 naira, you know, and they give them house, just a cubicle, maybe in one room there will be like 4 or 5 to live there. This is the camp. This area, when you hear area, you think area is one prime minister. Area is a stupidity of a black people. That stupidity they have. Where they come from, they transport it to from Atlantic Ocean or cross Sahara Desert with leg. As they are coming, as they are taking from that Atlantic Ocean, that area is following them. Each point area from that Atlantic Ocean to the camp where they are suffering, area is still with them. And I know why they are frustrating that guy, because that guy himself don't have paper. Do area here, do area. Even only give me sign. That is not comfortable with me. You see, people are already calling me because I normally I work with police, but it's on under social. But this one is, I will give you a criminal police that for to the rest of your life. Either you see yourself in Murtala Mohammed Airport, then you can now follow baboon like you and be doing AA in Nigeria. Here we are hustling to help our people. Our people are suffering. We came here to learn one or two things, to carry home, educate those at home, or to bend down and help our parents, because as it stands now, they are in pains and in problem. No work, those that are working, no salary. You came here and be doing a shoroti. Shoroti is begging. Camp is what do you call it? Refugee camp. Those that don't have paper, no house, nowhere, no livelihood. They are not working, they have no paper to work. Is that people that are threatening somebody that I give you only 2 minutes so that I don't want to be seen this. And sometimes when I see these people like this at the verse, even him that is talking at the verse,
they give you small change for camp. I don't need to make a hustle. Like that, you, this Auchi guy say lie. He no go ever leave this guy till he kill him.
Now, wow.
Because say really, because say yes, I'm okay, fine. That guy with the key for Roma Temelin or somewhere they close to Roma Temelin. Nobody know between the grudges where they between that guy and that guy will be say as that Benin guy will stab Abo guy to death. Nobody know.
Now, wow, this thing happened in Italy. No wonder, because they have been stabbing people to death. They think it's like that everywhere. Now, wow, so he stabbed somebody to death or far away Italy, not even in African country. Two of them left the journey and came in here, and after they came in here, not even a police kill him or maybe a citizen. It is his own fellow frustrated brother that stabbed him to death. I hope people are following. You see why we are so mad on these people. We don't need any. See, Mazen Namdekan, in case you come across this video, if you want to do any consultation with these people, I will go against this struggle. We don't need these people. Peacemaking is not for these people. We will take these people to where they come from. That area, they will be doing it inside Atlantic Ocean with the fish. I think they are into area. We will know. We will know when the time comes. We will know.
The God is waiting between them. Now you God with the heaven and know what you have or people around them. Me, I don't know. If you be saying that one of two problems that don't they get, and I make him call the threat, I say go kill him. I was okay. I think this is about one person not see call me. He say, Baba, starting to happen. Some Bini guy, listen to me very well. Some, because most of them go they waste when they say Bini people. I'm not generalizing this thing as Bini people. I'm saying some, S-O-N-E, some.
Me say O-A-L-O-L. You own not some. Anybody that is paying allegiance to Oba, all of them are courtists. You don't know? You want to hide them? Now they hate people, they talk with fear. I don't like people that speak with fire. Get out from here. If you talk some, come off the road. I know they like people where they talk their fear. Come on, come out. Who says some? Anybody that is paying allegiance to this man is that illegal people. All of them. Matisola, calm down. I know the stupidity of Africa disturbs brain. Calm down. Intelligent people are watching. Calm down. Relax. But you know the stupidity of a black man. Sometimes it makes you lose your chain. I'm on that chain now. But sometimes I don't want to calm down. It's okay. Listen to him. Just 1 minute. 1 minute. It's okay. 1 minute. 1 minute. On a wee with my brother. It depends. You see where we come from? Those that enter through flight, you know how many hours journey? If they look, those that, have you ever been sitting inside the plane? You are asked with penny, you are asking when is this plane landing? Which plane is so far? Then let alone those that take leg from one country to another one, they still come here and be doing air. Not that they do air, it ended there. They stab their own fellow to death. I still have their videos here. I don't know whether if I show this video, whether Facebook will block me because this is my second Facebook. My first Facebook was blocked because if I start showing things that I see here, you will cry. I have a Bini, two Bini, this one two, not even a Abo, two Bini people. One carry dagger, hit, the thing penetrate, blood was pumping out like this. He here. I downloaded it, I said, I will show it. I don't know. My first Facebook was blocked. I will be open on 13th of March. If I show it again, they may block it. Oh God. Kevin Diashi Biani Bikon. Where did these people come from? These people are not from Africa. There's another a planet that is existing that we don't know. This is where these people come from. Another planet beneath the earth. This is where this kingdom exists. Maybe mistakenly. Either maybe tsunami. Or maybe wind blow. You see them, blow them out of the earth. And then they started creating. How can I come to Western world? I come here to be doing courtism. Can you just imagine? In Western world, if people are doing it at home, I understand them. Exposure. But me and you travel all the way from Atlantic to come out in Western world. And we are seeing how people are behaving. Even Italians that are even mafias in their own. When they talk, they fight for things that have meaning. Mega money, they're talking. These people don't even care for money. Now just a bobo. If they feel say you be big boy, if they say you pass me, I could tell you say I be here. Oh yeah. I need one minute. Play.
Some Bini people, listen to your ear. As in open your ear, make you listen to me very well. Some Bini people will be say they are very, very stupid and very, very senseless.
Oh yeah.
Yes, let me talk up.
Yes.
Some people are very stupid and very senseless. No, the same person go bury what did they do before. Then make us stupid because if we start to the uproot, what did we done bury before? You know, go easy between Agbo people and some Agbo people and some Edo people. I'm telling the truth. Because when this man tell me what he be, I said, I see your picture of Jimmy. When I see the picture of the man, he's an advanced person. He said, get three children from Nigeria. We say, he need to take care of. But one guy wake up from Edo State, from beneath, from Awuchi, we say, be here, he got a threaten and we caught. He say, one day go kill him. I go, okay, fine and good. Before this guy go kill you. We won't bring the matter for social media. So anything happen to this Agbo guy, this Anyoma guy, this Eka person, make Anyoma people, Agbo people know it's okay. Now one out of people kill him. Because as I talk to you now, the guy that they make contact within a year people made they kill this guy simply because of waiting. I don't know. Simply because, okay, we can walk for the same place. Okay, this guy get 3 places away for the hustle. Three supermarket away for the hustle.
Oswell, it's okay. Now, I know, you know what is their problem? If I tell you what is their problem, you never believe it. Those that are watching, know what is their problem? Wow. Their problem is also related to Biafra. Where is my land? Where is my site? Where they are hustling? When you hear hustling, let me use the proper word because we are not here to paint word. Where they are begging? They have tennis supermarket where they beg. Maybe say Mula, Bila, Spa, for those that have it in, you know, Lidl. Those people, those place they are begging. They are, this one that want to kill him said is his place. This is my position. Don't come here to beg. It's my own position to beg. 3 places. So maybe when he come to beg there, this guy that have 3 children have already stayed there. And they need to be struggling who go out from each other. But when you see us clamoring to restore our place, to make so that you people can will stop begging, it become a problem. That's the problem. Now, no, you know that thing. Okay, this one has gone. I don't want to finish it. Like I told you, we are in a big mess. We are in a big mess. Let me not talk again. I have a lot of it. Let me show you one video before I expect call. Because I have a lot. I downloaded more than 20. More than 20. Even the women fighting in the Uber. Naked themselves. Naked. The problem is that it's white people that used to separate them.
Do you want to apply police call? What do you want to all of us call also? Eh?
When they hear hustle, no be work could they do. No be government work, you they hear hustle. No be say then they even there inside the press computer, we say okay, hustle they on their own. Hustle means begging. Anytime you hear hustle for Europe, they know they do G here. G no be for Europe. Everywhere they tight here. You can do G for Asia, no be here. Anytime you hear hustle here, now begging. Or those ones that are doing all these 50-50, maybe say 5-5 or drugs. You know, at the end of the day, they will catch you. You go and spend how many years in prison? Maybe you come out, you go or you stay. You know? Well, this is another hustle. Nonsense. Tarnishing our image here. Look at how he stabbed his brother. I will show you the other one. Let me see whether this one I can show. This is another one. But the other one is so deadly.
Okay, see what you do, you know. Well, I'm not hitting a bed. Eh? But see that guy, nothing move now. What is that? Now you're happy now. You know they're happy now. Okay, now what you know saying what happened now? We are black, we be Nigeria. Why would we care like this? Tomorrow now you're safe on Facebook everywhere.
You don't come back. I'll show you.
See that guy, you could have took somebody. Okay, you didn't took somebody just now. You know who think? That guy, I believe you for took a belly.
Don't worry.
See how white people are looking like. Look at white people. See white people are looking like.
You
see him? Now they see him. Oh well. We continue.
Now I have to open my line. And somebody is aggravated because now they cannot say Nigeria is a zoo. And somebody is having problem because now they cannot say Nigeria is a zoo. I know Oba is they are in court now. I know Oba is a cultist. I know. Are you telling me? If he's not a cultist, how will he have the mind to go and naked somebody's father that is speaking? That guy that spoke with us here 2 days ago, Murphy, they naked his father. Take a video of him in the market square. You know, so this is what we need to come out of. That is what we are doing. Nnamdi Kanu have never supported something like this. And that is why most of us say yes. You know, we need to live like a human. That's all. That's what that guy is saying. I didn't see any other thing that guy is talking. You know? This is another one. This is their women everywhere. If it's not their men. Again, certain useless Benin people, they will tell us now maybe it's a concocted story. Look at it, useless Benin people. Where? Why you no go marry your own black race? You go marry a white person. If you born children now, you don't know it's their own. Instead of you to go and marry a fellow black person. Out there, these are the people. You say we go marry. I am comfortable with what I have. I am comfortable. I keep myself. Nobody know my secret. Nobody. It's only two people that know about me in this, the whole Europe. Only two people. Only two. And those two people, I know how it started. Amanda Nez. Atlantic Ocean, my brother, that's... Anybody, if he's a human being, I will sue him to court. Or him and that Sarah Desert. All this nonsense is their causes. I don't blame them fighting. And do you know what pains me? Is the white people that used to separate them. That's the problem I have. Had it been they fight and go, no problem. White people will come and be dragging them. I see where they say Africano. No, they are speaking it. In Italy. Italy is like Nigeria. In terms of coordination. I think. Because this thing cannot happen in Germany anyhow, just like that. I have sent two people home before. Me, I did it, and I am proud of it. I sent two Somalians back to their country land. And if I still see a way to send those from our place, I will send them back home. I did it, and I'm proud. I'm happy. Two people, I sent them back home. They were fighting. I never knew they don't even have paper. They were fighting. I went there. I said, please. Stop this. Just look around you. These are white people passing. And it's only people that... They even want to fight me. I just press 133. I don't want to waste time. 131. Put... Ausweis means your identity card. Your card. Ausweis be there. They don't have anything. From there. That's the end. I was there maybe like 1 week. They're telling me there are some two people they say they sent back home because they were fighting and I have no paper. I said, no, I'm the one that called the police. Very proud. Very proud. So that when you come Europe, you face what you came for. Look at how they are disgracing themselves. Maybe as they are stabbing themselves, they have no paper. Because anybody that have a meaningful life will not be running the street, doing a bubble, doing a year, doing a year. Near them for my corner. Near for my corner, they do a year. Then I go, I hear you here. We can do it at home, no law. After all, when we are in school, our lecturer is also among the courtists. If you go meet in that time, you see lecturer. VC is also a member, pilot, VC. Lecturer, they are there. If you do it at home, I know it's the stupidity of African system. But they don't carry that nonsense. Come here. You come here, you look around and see how people are behaving. Yes. First caller today. Hello.
Hello.
Yes, can you hear me?
Good morning from here.
Yeah. Good evening from here. Where are you calling from and what is your name?
How you analyze the whole thing?
Oh, my brother, I know your voice. This is our brother from Anambra, because the day I refer you as an Israeli. You told me I should know because
I am not from Anambra, I'm from Omambara.
Correct. Again.
I have to correct that.
Ah yes. Right. Correct. From Omambara.
So we need to go back to our roots.
Yeah, correct. Pardon me for that. Yes.
I'm Israeli Biafran.
Correct.
I'm proudly Igbo. I love my people.
Correct.
We're going home. So the thing is that I listened to the ranting, that guy was reacting nonsense. And I'm so grateful about Mohammed Dike, one of Africa.
Correct.
The only one that is opening the eyes of my African people. But I still have problem with him. Stop calling my people black.
That's Uzo. Uzo is speaking, yes. Yeah.
But we have to correct that later. We are going on.
Correct.
All right. I'm so happy my people are waking up.
For sure.
The good of me good are waking up.
Correct. Especially,
when
yes.
When I told them that Edo is Biafra, they keep attacking me. Oh, go back to Israel. How can you tell us our history? I told them, you are Africans, or you don't know who you are. They don't know who they are. That is why I wrote you in the book, Open Up These People Out. How can you be in river and you're washing your hand with saliva?
I'm telling you.
What is wrong with these people? You're running after the albinos. They call them albinos. I'm not insulting anybody because you can't equate people with color. Democracy started in Igbo land.
Yes.
These are the greatest people on planet Earth, the Jewish people. I'm still going to come there telling them they don't want to listen, they don't want to hear anything. You don't know who you are, and people are mesmerizing with your brain. You don't want to reason. You're suffering. Yes, you are living in another man's land. And they talk about how you open your stinking mouth, you're yapping nonsense. I told my uncle, they said I'm going to apologize. That was now, this is 10 years now. No, it's 12. 2000, I told him 2002. Oh, this is your children, they're not going home. Iken is not going home. Iken is an American. Oh, this is talking rubbish. Oh, you don't tell us what. Don't tell us this. My grandfather died 2 years ago. The great man the first man that had Biafran lorry in America, New York. I shared the video. The video is everywhere. You know what happened? We went to Nigeria and we went down to blessed Biafran land with Beretti. The humble man that always tells us the truth. The man that made all of us to speak Igbo in a family. After that, we went back to America. You know what he came and told my uncle?
Oh.
Ain't gonna come to this country again, bullshit. My uncle got a mansion. The mansion is there. He came and openly told him, I'm not going home. I hate this. So much noise everywhere is smelling. I don't belong here. He rang the police, and he told the police, anytime my dad sent me here, I'm gonna do something that will surprise everybody. You see, my dear? Oh, everybody, I know, most of them think that it's not of their business because they are living fine. It concerns everybody. Let me repeat, all of us living outside our country, we are all slaves.
For sure, for sure. For sure.
All of us, we are all slaves. That's why I'm telling them I don't want what happened to us in Israel to happen to our boyfriends. We're scattered over the world. My mom, my dad's brother was buried in America. What is happening? We need to get our home. And another thing, I said it. If I preach about religion, they talk rubbish. Oh, concentrate on my Biafra. Leave religion out of this. They blind you with religion. You're talking rubbish about religion. Pray straight to Chukwuka Biama in heaven. It's all about Jesus. The Romans came and killed Yeshua and changed the name and put down the New Testament for you, and you are there talking rubbish in Africa. They slap you here, you turn the other way, they slap you, and they keep killing you guys. You don't stand up and defend your land. My people are waking up. I thank you, my brother.
Correct, correct.
I'm burning with fury.
Correct.
Because my people, I don't know what happened. You know why I'm angry now? Before, I used to tell them, I teach them mildly. But now it's happening. They're seeing killings. Anybody that doesn't want to wake up now, I wonder when will the person wake up? I don't know. There's something wrong with the way Africans reason. And that is why we are in the same spot.
Correct.
And listen, if they don't want to make haste wide of sunshine, you know, stagnant water, once the water is stagnant, it stinks. That's why Africa is stinking, because they don't want to move forward.
Correct.
Shalom.
Correct. Correct, brother. Correct.
Bye.
Correct. So our brother also article, those that know him, he have contributed his own part. You that is fighting your own brother, what have you done? Nothing. At least he are putting his own in writing, you know, to make sure all this distorted history of ours is being brought to reality. There are people that you go to research and make your point, not just you run away. Now I'm here and I want somebody to call me and to tell me, in fact, anybody that is calling me now, before I will pick your call, you must talk Biafra Tobeo. If not, I will quit you. This is what you must say, Biafra Tobeo. This is how you're gonna be this night. Because that alleges to respect you pay. This is even more valuable than that thing you people are talking Tobeo. Oh yeah. Yes, hello.
Hello, good evening, sir.
Yeah, good evening, my brother.
Yeah, good evening. I can hear you. Can you hear me?
I can hear you, please. There's a rule I set now. This is how it is. Biafra Tobeo, before you speak.
No, I'm not. I don't know what is Tobeo. My name is Jerry. I'm a full Biafra.
Okay, brother. Okay.
So, I listened to the guy that was debating Muhammad Dike.
Yeah.
So the thing is, what I will only advise my brothers, if you're running the program of this, if you're discussing about our close-door neighbors, the Benins or the Edos, you won't end this program. You won't end the program. You talk about them for 10 years.
I know.
You still have much and much to talk every day.
Yeah.
Like Madike rightly said, and there was a time I called you that you said you're gonna call me so that I will talk much about the Bible.
Ah, my brother, I have to be honest with you. I remember now, but you know, I have a lot of calls, and sometimes. It depends on the mood I am when the call came. I remember, I will not deny. I remember, I think, okay, it's you.
Yeah, it's me.
Oh, sorry.
Let that be discussion for
another. I will call you tomorrow for it. I promise.
Okay. So
I will note your number now.
Contribution.
Yes.
Okay. This is my number, sir.
Yes.
So what I've been with Edo guys, Benin guys. You get very little percentage of them that are calm. But majority of them, they like autism. They like boiling like hot water. You know.
Mm.
When there is no need to boil, you see them boiling. So I think it's in their nature.
Yes.
If I am to decide who is going to be join Biafra, if by the grace of Chukwuka Abiam, we actualize Biafra, which we are going to actualize not long from now, I will say they will not even smell getting closer, because those guys, they are thinking their way of life and everything didn't match. It didn't match. They're too violent for my liking. They're too violent. But the girls, their girls is different from their men.
But their girls, for me, their mind is, they remember whom, at least I was there for 1 year. I served there for 1 year. What I observe is that is most of their women that do develop that place. I'm telling you.
Yeah, the women do hustle. The women hustle, and the guys, what they do is things. They come over here in Europe and Italy and every other place, and what they know is courtism.
Mm.
Courtism. So when courtism is, if you see the way they treat the women, beat girls in the streets, stalls one hour of life, things that are too appalling to, you know. So, but you just have to throw them into the trash and move on with the latest development that will enhance our movement, our agitation, you know, things that is going to help now, like run a program on how to support ECN or things like that.
Okay.
But if it is about those people, their mind is too backward. They will wake up, but things that takes you, you know, things that you will see now, it will take them 30, 50 years for them to get to the level of what you're seeing now. You understand?
Mm.
So I don't see the reason why a young boy that you're supposed to be in your country, but the country denying you opportunity that was supposed to, that you benefit that you're supposed to gain from the country, and you're running all over all streets of Europe, and you're still shouting Nigeria, Nigeria, Nigeria. What has Nigeria done for them? Nothing. The so-called, I was discussing with one of them last week, but that one was calm and sensible anyway, not like the rest of them. And I asked the guy a question. Since ever you were born in Benin, he said yes. I said, what has this Oba done for you people?
Mm-hmm.
What industry, what development has he attracted to Benin that makes him this so-called Oba all the time? What has he attracted in terms of development? Well, in terms of, say, for the sake of Oba, we got this thing than selling all their land and intimidating them. And
what was his response?
No, he didn't say anything. He said the man has not done anything for us. Not done anything. So, but I'm not. They are too timid. They are too timid. Maybe it's the level of their brain. Yeah, it's the level of their brain. And one funny thing with them again is, if you meet 50 of them, they all behave the same, even the old and the young men of them.
They do courtesy, whether the one that are 60 or 70 or that are here. I didn't the same. Best of the same feather flows together. Let me tell you, brother, to recap so that other people can call in. Let me tell you why I'm doing this. If you know me,
okay.
If you know me, you know I am basically for religion, and that is where you met me.
I talk how to emancipate our people from the version of religion we have in Africa and the one we see in Western world. I am trying to clarify to them that they are not the same. What people take as religion in where I come from is not what these people take it for. And these are the people that brought us that thing we have been worshiping. So, but as I'm doing it, other things are coming in. And necessity is the mother of invention. I was here and a lot of things is going on. When I look back, I've met them on the road. When I look back, like as I was saying, we were still in court with them here. The reason is that they came to a stadium, collected our flag from one of the cowardly Biafran. I will say it in that way because no brave man into this world will allow somebody to take a symbol. That flag is a symbol. It's overall symbol that somebody, I can die with it if anybody collect it from me. It's a symbol of honor. And they took it from this guy. And they also come to where we are doing meeting before and asking this Biafra, why do you people want this Nigeria? I mean, to go out from Nigeria. You know, and the stuff like this, invading, you see how this one is questioning Nnamdi Kanu, this one, why are you calling Nigeria zoo? And the subsequent ones. So, and the why I am coming is that our people, like if you watch my 2 days program, is about exposure. Those guys, that guy you are talking, maybe from Igodo. That guy that you say you are talking and he keep calm. They are not the same people. They are different. They are different people that is in that particular region.
That one is not Ishan. I know Ishan.
Uh-huh. Not only Ishan.
Ishan is quite different from the, I don't know how to call them, the Benins or the Do. The thing is they're too diabolical in.
No, they are not. Not those ones that are diabolic are the ones that are pay allegiance to Oba. That's those that are don't pay allegiance to Oba. They can talk to you in a camp place when you meet them in a private. They will talk to you, be open to you. But those that believe that Oba is their God, they can do and do to defend. Even Oba raped their mother. They will say yes, what he did is good. So, people, they are different. Had it been we didn't start this journey, we won't have known so many things that is coming to our doorstep now. So many things is involved in this thing we are doing. And this is why I am here. I am not happy that people are... look at how... go to internet now. Look at how they are insulting Mazen Nadekan everywhere. If you see the way the one they call Winde Civilian used to talk about him in their forum, and they are talking, yes, that man, you know, he's a criminal. He's a fraudster, IPO pigs. You know, they are just bringing all sorts... they've never met that man before. The man has never met him before. But you know, so...
Have they got anything to offer? Like, even if Nnamdi Madike is fraudster or whatever, is he defrauding them?
I don't know.
Have they given anyone one shilling to IPO before?
He insulted their Oba. But I played the clip here now. This man said, I respect the man a lot. I respect the institution. I respect him so much. I cannot. But many people are still calling him. And now he later realized that people that are calling him are entrapped in that place. They don't speak out. My brother, let us just leave it like this. Thank you very much for your call. And like I said, I will call you tomorrow so that regarding the issue we left undone last time.
Yes, there is something we really need to educate you or talk to you.
Don't say educate me. Don't say educate me. Say there are something we really need to discuss and debate, not educating me.
Educate, I mean it's you knowing whom you are.
I know who I am. Then on
sure.
Yes, you see I'm so you want to tell me that you know me more than I know myself.
No, I mean knowing whom you are is you are the real Israelite of the Bible.
I have nothing to do with the Bible. Please. I don't want us to talk about this thing. Now, Bible is written by men like me and you. I told you, this is the today program is not all about Bible or religion. Tomorrow, I will open your eye. I will show you the quotation in Bible where you see chapter 1. You didn't see chapter 2. You will see chapter 4. Don't worry. Tomorrow, I'm going to call you. We will talk about it.
Okay, bro.
Yes, yes.
Okay, bro. Okay, well done. What you're doing is not easy. Well,
I know.
So keep it up.
All right, brother. All right, brother. May God bless. Bless you.
Good night.
Bless you. Good night, brother.
You too, man.
Correct, correct. I want to show you something about, this guy may be Igodo. Look at him now. Maybe he's from Igodo. Look at his response. He's begging. And we need to come to their rescue. The guy is begging. It's from Edo. It's from Edo.
I'm so full and ears may not go block on the road. I beg, share this video, may everybody see. I'm full and ears may not block on the road. Travelers where they go on Lagos today. Stay on the road for good 28 hours. No movement. Why? Because full and ears may not block the road. I beg, if Edo State Government, Ondo State Government, and Lagos State Government, no fit do anything, I'm worried. That was everyone prefer cow pass Mabe. If we no fit do anything about this on the road, more I just call Eastern Security Network, may they help us. Unamdi Kanu, I beg. Mazi, Unamdi Kanu, I beg. Call your Eastern Security Network people, may they help us for this on the road matter. Because this is a motorcycle, come like in a month the day. What it be saying to just to carry full and ears may come up from or a road? No problem. Every day, people, motorists, and even those flying that road, they are not safe. It can't be like saying if you don't pass or a road, you know they safe at all. Imagine full and ears may just block road.
Yes, can you hear me?
Biafra.
Oh, hey, Biafra, very fast, brother. I have overstayed my time here and I want to take like maybe say 10 calls before I go today. What is your name and where are you calling from, brother?
I'm calling from Germany. I'm from Benin.
You are from Benin? Oh, I love that. Okay.
Actually, I will beg you for one thing.
Okay.
You know, somebody live in prison for 30 years and you give him freedom. He will not go out. He will let
go out. brother, wait. Let me recap. Our brother said he's from Benin. He said somebody have been in prison for so many years and he give him freedom. He will not go out. I love that. Continue, brother.
You see what is happening? You know, Israelites live in captivity for 400 years. You see how the history still remains today. People are still saying it. 400 years. Do you know how many hundreds of years this brown Arabs, they migrated from Sudan. All those Somalia, they are brown people. They have dwelt in our land for close to 800 years. It's not really easy. And what they use in capturing the heart of our people, fear. Mm. They introduce secret cults and idol with the using our people. So what I'm trying to say is that you see these secret cults that is rampaging in Benin was i.e. black ass was founded in Oba Palace. The reason why it was founded is to control the mindsets of the people. Fear that used to control the mindset of people. The reason why people respect government is because of gun. You know?
Yeah.
Without force, nobody will respect the authority. When you make law, we use force, people respect it. You know? This our people, you see those elect Bino, their name, don't call them Bini people, you call them elect Bino misbloods. They are misbreeds.
Okay.
These people are mixed with people from Ilife or Romeo family. It's not their fault. They were brainwashed. Just imagine, you were born in Kano, you are a Muslim. After you have lived there about 50 years, someone will come and tell you, Islam, it's not the right way. How will you feel? Don't you need to take a long time to convince you, for you to know the see the light.
Mm-hmm.
You see, the people you are seeing today, they are claiming that they are the owner from here to everywhere. But have you seen what is going on? We have 18 local governments, but have you ever seen anybody from Asia say, oh, we are Benin Kingdom? No. Have you ever seen anybody from the other side, Akoko, Edo, Auchi, all those areas say they are Benin Kingdom? They are none of them is accepting it. So I want to beg you. You see, those people, in English they call it stark illiterate. These people are stark primary school dropouts.
Mm.
Most of them, ask them what is their qualification. They are primary school dropouts.
Yeah, correct.
So you cannot be a professor to be debating with a primary school dropout.
Yeah, correct.
It is going to be so I am using this opportunity to call on you.
Okay.
And you see, I was watching you say during the Civil War, before the Civil War, Benin was taking over under 8 hours. You see, what I'm about to tell you, our people are hungry of freedom. The reason why they are not speaking out, because when somebody speaks, Oba Abinu will send people to go and kill him secretly.
Mm-hmm.
Or they will poison him. They are doing all sorts of things.
Yeah, poison. It's true.
That doesn't mean people are not hungry for. You see, these people who are coming out of social media, they are from the lineage of the Oba family and their gang who migrated from Ife. So what is going on in Benin, those people are not informed. It's not their fault. It's not going to easy. If you compare Bible during the time of Jesus Christ, Jesus Christ was saying, according to the Bible, he said he was the Messiah of the Jews. They said, no, you know, you can't. You know, this thing have been in this environment for so long. In those days, we challenge Yoruba of Benin. If you challenge Yoruba of Benin, they will come to your village, capture everybody in your village, and sell them to Portuguese, and use those family for human sacrifice. You see this type of traumatization and horror. That's why you see when you mention the name of Yoruba, people scared because of the evil and atrocity they committed in those days. For you to really know, ask any Benin man who is educated, ask him, is it true that the Yoruba Benin is using people for human sacrifice?
It's true. I've asked. After that, I've asked. Somebody told me yes.
So, what is going on now? It's not because of they see somebody insult the Oba Benin. Am I not from Benin? I'm insulting the Oba. They took me to court. I win them. And so what I'm trying to say is that what happened in this, what led to the civil war, history wants to repeat itself. My grandmother told me in those days, this Igbo were the owner of this land before. This is where they come from. So the Oba Benin know this history, that the people who own this land will come back one day and take what belongs to them. The Oba Benin who is claiming he owns land, he's not from Edo State. He's from Ile Ife. He met the people there and drove a lot of people away. So to cut everything short so that other people can also call,
yeah.
I want to please beg you.
Okay.
You know, it's not, let us take it like evangelism.
Okay.
Our people are, if you lock somebody inside the cage, he will not think normal like somebody who is moving free outside. People, somebody who is free in a free world and somebody inside prison, that is a fallacy, that inside words and outside words.
Mm-hmm.
These people, their mindsets need to be loose. Please, in the name of God, help us. Take it as an evangelism.
I will.
They are trying to provoke you. They are trying to provoke freedom.
I will, brother. I've heard
when
the advice.
When they provoke freedom, we will let them know we have the weapon.
Mm.
The weapon is we will use evangelism to win them over to our brothers.
Correct.
The mixed blood among those people, they are not close to 1%. Mm. They don't even have. So if they are saying they want to have Benin Kingdom, my brother, when the time reach, where their land is, if they bring land from Ile Ife, they should come and tell us where they bring their land from. Because you cannot come from Ile Ife and say you want to have kingdom in another man's land.
Mm.
You're not going to. We have our own king. Our king is Ogiamie. Ogiamie is the king of our land, not Oba. Oba is a foreigner. Thank you very much.
Correct, man.
God bless you.
Correct. Bless you, brother.
Thank you.
Bless you. I later realize it's our lecturer 2 days ago, he made a point. I accept you. Like I told you, I'm always open to take correction. You know, sometimes we are human. We go out of our limit because of injustice you see meted against your own fellow human. That does nothing to you. Rather, he just trying to wake you up from your state of stupidity. And that is why they said, mental slavery is one form of slavery that make you to see your oppressor as your own, Messiah. Why do you see those fighting for you as your enemy? That is why we are speaking in this way. And yes. Can you hear me from here? Very snappy, brother.
Good evening, sir, bro.
Yes, good evening.
Good evening, sir.
Yeah.
Good evening, sir, bro. All right, Biafra. Bro, say, I beg, no vex. I beg, get one caller, we call you just now. They say, may you leave this program. Maybe you know they do it. The bros, I beg, because we know they lack. If anybody call you, maybe as they do this program, so maybe you stop this program. Maybe you know they do it.
No, you say,
no, they know they call you.
I know, I understand.
If that guy no one contribute, may not they call you again. You know why they thought this thing?
No.
Wait till they do so, and a big thing. Me even see they do myself, because you know why? Most of our Igbo Biafra, they say they fear that about Benin too. But Sammy, so even this man will call you your star now. He even see they fear himself. That's why they read Bible for you, your star. You don't understand that? If they fear that about Benin, but Sammy, so the man don't put fear for so many people, man. Say, now Jesus Christ, and a foolish person. Now, just person will watch people. For that place, what did they do? So you know many people when they wake up, you they wake most of our people we be say they put them for mental slavery for many years. They see they the slave, you they wake them up every blessed day. But person will they call you there, you say, and no, may you leave this one, may you go another side. No, if you want call for this program, if you don't want contribute, wait to make you call, don't call to tell him to leave it, because you don't know the work where they do for the for the Benin people. You don't know what way they do for them. No, say many of them, they European, they show up Benin and they are Jesus Christ. They European, they show up Benin and they are Jesus Christ. They say won't vanish, won't kill them for a year. They are mindset will not be like that.
I know.
If you send West Coast, go give all of them. See, what they would do. Even coronavirus come, my bros. This man say me they not pack. Maybe they pack those beans. Miss Cooper, maybe they pack up. Company will complete your program. Will be telling you that.
My brother, maybe you are referring to somebody before the last caller, because this one I just finished now never told me to.
Before this last caller, that one they told you about Bible,
okay,
Bible,
okay.
Whatever.
Okay, correct.
Bible, this one. Mm. Please don't make them only call for this program. They tell you, go do this. If you don't want to list it, go and list it to this CNN. We are here. Our people is here.
Correct.
Some people, our people, they want to wake up here. They are listening to you.
They're waking up.
They're waiting for you to come online. But somebody will come. Don't do it like this. Our Igbo Biafra, please. Another program day. IPOB is on. They're not asleep. We're not asleep in the night again. IPOB day everywhere. If you don't want to this thing, you leave it, because you don't know what it is that they do to our people. You won't see they are afraid of further than Benin, because we want to remove our people for mental slavery.
They will come out.
And our people, they guide that now, putting our coin they use. Okay, can you imagine that man? He can't let his daughter wait they use before. The lady daughter, he don't do, he don't work again. He carry gun, give her, make go, they take the fight. Say no, take do not work again. Give her gun, go and cut class. Say that, beg, this thing don't work. Make go use gun and cut class. They chase people, they go. They chase the rules, they chase the use, they go for their various community. This is not good, because we need to wake our people. The day Western warrior, no one of them see the day on sleep. The government, they defeat them. Government, they take care of them. But they believe somebody believe in Jesus Christ. That mindset not good. You don't go for this
correct,
for this kind
correct,
of generation.
Correct. Correct, man. Correct. Bless you, brother. Bless you, brother. I love this call. I love it. I want to advise our people. You see this last call. I see what he said that I love. He said after juju, when juju no work, they give and gone. You see that gone? Now wait till they walk. I tell you, sir, I don't serve. You know when I told you I serve native daughter, most people will think I am just joking. I have served. Can you see somebody who has served native doctor? I served him for 9 years. We do sacrifice, we do incantation, we invoke. But he's so honest to me. He told me it is only two things that works perfectly: poison and something that have it must have contact with your body. You see, this thing you call poison. These are what white people call chemical. It can be acid, any form of concentrated acid. It can be those that are chemists. I mean, those that are chemistry students. You know what is called concentrated tetraoxosulfosic acid, or you have sodium acid, whatever. When you mix concentration, maybe say H2SO4 plus any AO4, whatever, sodium hydroxide, it will give you sodium tetraoxosulfosic. If you try and touch it in your body will start decaying. Our people are poison. I have an uncle here, and he died. May his soul rest in peace. He died of leukemia. It takes, you know, hospital here, they will tell you this is the time you are going to die, because it's the cancer of the bloodstream. We never knew that some people in the village have started persecuting one man. That is the man. that they kill him. Somebody from there, you know, all these superstitious belief, it makes you, it cage you, it puts you in prison. I remember when we are growing up, if you are walking in darkness, you will think that something is following you. You do immediately, it is in you, it's inside you. You know, something you have built up in you, you must see it. You do like this. That thing that is in your mind, you will see it. Fear, fear you are putting into yourself. Watch, check, if you have a picture now in your house, continue looking at that picture. When you look at the picture, you will think the picture is looking at you. You are the one looking at the picture. Even when you are, you want to remove your eye and you are using this one to be watching, the picture is looking at you. You are the one looking at the picture, not the picture looking at you. It is that level of, you know, level of illiteracy and intimidation we grew up with, believing that somebody can just come from somewhere and come and kill you here. We need to wake up. That is why, maybe that my brother, I have been in this program because of religion. That my brother just called before this Lakola will testify. This is where our problem lies, religion. Is the cop, forget this, this or that one. Religion breeds stark illiteracy. Religion will make you feel like a fool. If you see this big man in church, wear suit, wear tie. When they say Holy Ghost fire, you will see them, Holy Ghost fire, I receive. Close here. Somebody invited me to child education. You know, I said, let me honor as a friend. When they say everybody stand on your feet, I was sitting down. They were saying, Holy Ghost fire, continue. This is how I'm looking. I look around like this. People are shouting on my head. I look back like this. Look at them shouting Holy Ghost fire. I went to that same church. They brought their envelope to give offering. I put hand in my pocket, bring out Biafran flyer, use pen, write it, pray for Biafran restoration. I put it there. I don't know, in the next church, they're asking, can you teach this people after money? The next church, they announced, somebody came here and put this Biafran flyer and saying, pray for Biafran. It's like people don't have a respect for God. Somebody put Biafran flyer and tell you to pray for Biafran restoration. Then it become an insult to God. I don't want to deviate that. That was the topic of another day. This is what I've been before this issue came up. And I love it. I love it. Yes. Can you hear me from here? Hello?
Hello.
Yes. Very fast, brother. I pick your call. What is your name and where are you calling from?
I'm Okudirechukwu. I'm calling from you. I'm United Kingdom anywhere.
Okay.
There's a story I need to tell. About this Benin Kingdom.
Brother, don't be offended. I interrupted you. Like, how many minutes did you think it would take?
No, just a couple of minutes anyway.
Okay.
I just wanted to tell the story. You know, my great father, which is Ibuku,
mm-hmm.
came all the way from Ikodomingo.
Correct.
So when I was hearing all this story about it, I didn't know Benin was in Ikodomingo. My father have told me that.
Mm.
But now I've been listening to your channel. I remember that Ibuku doesn't, our own Igwe is called Idu.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
Idu, if what I'm telling you is true.
You know, which clan are you from, brother?
Obuno.
Uh-huh.
My great, because Ibuku, I think, has probably four wives, which is Obu, either four or five, Obuno, Ngo, Ndege, and two other crown anyway.
Yeah.
So, my great-great-great-grandfather came from Ikodomingo.
Abraham Hossa, they ran away, they chased them.
Because of Idu Noba.
Yes.
Because of that war that happened.
Correct. You know it.
And our dialects are different. Ibuku is in Normanbala, and our dialect, and Ibuku and Onitsha, they are similar, they are the same. I think when they moved, when they run all the way to Ibuku, I think from that Ibuku, some of them moved to Onitsha.
Our brother Murphy said this thing 2 days ago. Yes.
That's the only thing I want to ship. This is the history my grandfather told me.
Yeah, that guy.
His own grand
Yes.
His great-grandfather is the original. In his actual name is Iwuku. There are, I think there are people that fought. There are also included in people that fought war.
Yes.
During that period.
Yes, you are correct.
So they have to run away. They have no option.
Correct. Correct. Correct.
That is why our Igwe, they call them Idu. Not even Igwe.
Mm-hmm.
Not even Obi. We call them Idu. Our Igwe na Idu, they call them.
Hmm. Oh, wow.
Anyway, that's anything I want to share.
Thank you, brother. Thank you very much. Yeah, can you see that the thing is now relating somehow? Our brother Murphy told us 2 days ago that they chase a lot of people away. And as you are running away, your language is changing, which is normal. It varies. It may not delete completely, but it varies. It is out of fear, intimidation. Our parents were running. This time around, we died there. We are not running anywhere. You run, leave your compound, be running to my own side. You know, if we stand your own place, you are running, running for waiting. We no intimidation this time around. All of us will die in their clan. If war come there, we fight. So war come from my village, and I will run. We'll go on that place. Yes, can you hear me?
Hello, my brother.
Yes, where are you calling from, brother?
Yeah, I'm calling from Canada.
Wow, Canada, okay.
Yeah. Thank you for your good program.
Yeah, thank you very much.
You see, the... these are those people. The problem they have is, especially, is Benin City.
They said, I think a historian said, you know, that's why we need to teach ourselves. They said they are not, there is Ile Ibinu people. Ile Ibinu.
Yes.
Mm, yes.
That's where the problem lies. Mm. That, you know, that boy, that illiterate called Wounded Civilian.
So the one with the rainbow, the guy with rainbow color. The guy with rainbow color on the face.
Rainbow color, yes.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
With one girl, there is another one girl in Italy.
I know.
Always post nonsense.
I know.
Yeah,
I know.
They are the same place.
I know.
These people are slaves. They are slaves, or they are upper slaves.
Yeah.
The father, in fact, that died about 2 years ago. The father worked with Yoruba. These people, their knowledge is from Yoruba. Land.
I know.
That guy, in fact, have more than 30 wives.
No one is. You are correct.
He has that. All the 30 in the Benin, the 30 for Benin City, taking money from the government, the third woman. Is that guy family? He's in family.
That's why they don't want Biafra to come.
Yes, these people are fighting for Biafra because they know what they are getting from Benin.
Correct.
This is what they are fighting.
You are correct.
For their selfish interests, nothing again.
Yeah, correct.
That guy now, you see that bleaching guy, he live in Italy. He has no work. He has been in Italy more than 15 years. He came through the sea.
I know.
All these people you see here, all of them came through the Morocco and the Libya.
Exactly.
They're illegal immigrants before some of them got their paper. These people, they are not thinking about their people. Upper is holding his people blind.
I know.
Fetish man.
He's a fetish man.
This is the generation. Upper father that died last time, the father of this very one. The one man from a college, Isama of Benin, he can't the man go to court. They say the king cannot go to court. He can't the man go to court. He deserves the man. The man cried for court, the father of this very upper. He take him to court to discuss him. This man is holding the Benin people for blind, taking out their land. He's a criminal.
I know, we know.
Criminality.
We know.
Yeah, this is what he's doing.
We know nobody's above any God. Juju back up.
He doesn't have any juju.
Juju,
which juju? He swear for the Benin case, anyone that he collect money from abroad, this one, he will die. All the juju, nothing is working. That is to judge deceiving people.
It's slavery. Brother, it's slavery.
That is he have there. Yes, he's only threatening the people. He blind the people. Nothing is working. He hold the people blind. That bleaching guy, which they call Makajasin in Italy, the guy is just a dad. He have nothing.
Why are you, brother? Why are you people insulting Makajasin? Why are you people relating Makajasin to this guy? No. I cannot accept this. Mikey Jackson is a whale. No, please.
And the very poor guy, the guy don't have nothing. You want to compare a great man like Nnamdi Kanu to that. He never studied. I tell the guy one day, go to school and study. Know the history before they come to Nnamdi Kanu. Nnamdi Kanu is intellectual in everything.
You know why, brother? I'm very happy for your call, and I so much accommodate it. But the only thing I have to leave with you now before I disengage is that
we all have to be happy because Nnamdi Kanu have never have their time. They want their name to be mentioned.
So we need to be grateful
that we have somebody that ignore because they just want their name to be called. Like if you watch when Asare Dokubo were making noise, he just want that, and immediately Nnamdi Kanu call his name. Then you see how he's now coming every day online. Now we are not seeing them. Now you seeing them online? They are disappeared. Yeah, they are disappeared. Correct, brother.
It's a thought. You have nothing. You're taking an internet in the street.
We know, brother.
You want to compare with somebody like him, a great man like him. It's a thought, my brother. Thank you for the money.
Correct. Thanks, brother. Correct.
Open their eyes.
Correct. If you are watching me now, you have to always come out of that slavery. Fear. If I tell you what fear does in life, fear makes you not to achieve your potential because of unforeseen contingencies you have within your head. It can destroy you for life. Fear is not good in life. I'm telling you the truth. I'm not talking about you are living in Western world and you're afraid of somebody far away who will kill you. Because of your going against, if Trump is more valuable than Oba. I'm telling you, Trump, more valuable. Who else? Even the current president of America, they can criticize them. You know the humiliation Trump got, ranging from one cartoon to another, cursing him even in his presence. Even the Prime Minister of Boris Johnson of UK, those that didn't support this Brexit, you know people that are cursing him, throw garbage at him, he never take anybody to court. Even in this country here, there's somebody they call Strache, a very powerful man in this country. A small boy insulted him in front, carry camera and tell him get out. Nothing happened to him. And you are living in this country and you don't learn anything. It is called freedom of speech. Provided you are not using it to endanger the lives of other people. Just like I'm coming here and I'll be telling you, go and kill people. No. I can only tell you, go and defend yourself, which is what ESN stands for. And that's why we are supporting ESN openly. You think we are fool? Upon ESN, we are supporting everything. Now the country can still pass from one embassy to another, from one country to another, from one checkpoint, from one airport to another, and nobody will. Don't you think they don't know him? You think Americans or Europeans? He traveled to America, and they allow him travel cross border. They know him, and they know he's talking about ESN, and they saw that ESN is having gone. It is called to defend yourself. That is what he's doing. Terrorists, IPOB terrorist organization, IPOB, IPO bingos, they are terrorists, online country. That online country now is disturbing everybody on ground. Online, before you know it, you now will still remain online. They have come on ground. Yes, can you hear me? Speak up. What is your name and where are you calling from?
Yes. My name is Austin. Yep. I'm from Igolo land.
Okay, Austin, okay.
You understand?
Yeah.
So I'm calling from Italy here. Thank you for the program. I just see the program.
Mm-hmm.
I want to ask you a question. Can I ask you here? Is it true that we are all beyond France? That is Asian people. Please. Confirm for you, please.
I think that question is supposed to be addressed to your people, but what we are saying is that many Asian people are saying they are Biafrans, and according to the history, they are Biafrans, and we are not going to force them to become Biafrans. That is why we have what we call referendum for them themselves to decide whether they want to be Biafra or not.
Okay, no. I just, you see, them don't concern me. Me, I want to know if we have anything to do with Biafra. If they have anything to do with Biafra, me, I'm a Biafra. I declare myself already.
Okay.
You understand me?
Yes.
So anything they have to do with that or about that useless idiot, that all those people, all of them, we have to finish all of them. This life, you are an European, I'm mentally here. Look at what we are going through here.
No, nonsense.
Going through here, they don't see us as a human being. Our leader said last time, I'm not going to be here, what he said.
They don't see us. We are next to dustbin. We are next to shit.
I know. Depends.
You understand me? You understand what I said?
Yes, I know.
This is my first time seeing you for this program, and I just hope now I hear what you are talking. What you are talking makes so sense. You understand? It makes sense. So I love you so much.
Thank you, brother.
From today, I will be following you.
Thank you, brother. Thank you,
but
brother.
I think we're going to join her together to cleanse that land.
We'll clean it. People wake up.
For me, I've declared myself for Biafra.
Correct.
Because I've not seen any other human being now that is saying truth apart from this man. This is our Jesus.
Correct.
No, Jesus, the
if they hear you talk Jesus, they will kill yourself. If they hear you call him Jesus, they will kill yourself. You know? Correct, brother.
I call him Jesus. I call him Lord.
Correct.
I call him Savior.
Correct. Because correct.
I call him a prophet.
Correct.
There's no prophet in this world. I've not seen. No man, do useless people that build that house. They call it church. It's a shrine. They call it church. Those people are our problem.
I know.
They are our problem. Since 30 years, they are our problem. All those prophets, all those useless, all those pastors, they are our problem. None of them have ever come out now condemn all this thing happening. Because they are walking hand to hand with all these useless people. Because they are walking hand to hand to them. See, anyone that is going against him, against this our Jesus, against him and the canon, he will die. We will swallow all of them. We will finish all of them.
Correct.
Then we force. We are coming.
Correct.
Idiot people.
Beg of his brother. I know.
I'm not a boy. I'm more than 40 years.
I know.
A man with 40 years, you know what is good.
From your voice.
So full day, no movement.
Never stand for this truth.
Yeah.
Only this man. Then you come here, come want to come and play with the man. You insulting the man. I won't allow that.
I know, brother.
I'm not allowed that.
It's okay, brother.
What sense is that? See, that land, we are going to cleanse all the blood and we will clean it. We will clean all these roads should go. That man have soaked a lot of blood. Look at it now. They bring the cut it, they put for Igodomigodo, they put for Ebola, they put
everywhere.
You see, you know, we'll be killing themselves for what? Then that man will decide to leave. He will not leave. That is not going to leave. It's not going to leave. We are not going to leave it today. All the lines will be cleansed. We will clean all everything so that we go forward.
Correct,
thank
brother.
You very much for the program.
Thank you, brother.
I'm calling you. Thank you. This is my direct number. Thank you. I will call you and talk to you.
Correct,
you
correct.
I love people. This only, I'm telling you, let them, I don't want them to hear now. This only Jesus will have.
I know.
Jesus will have it. Jesus our time.
Correct.
Please.
Correct.
Let them know this Jesus and prophet of our time.
Correct.
No more prophet. He's only one that says something that happened. I never hear anyone say. He's individual say anything that happened. You the police anything. Look at when they're supposed to go and protest. What is it called? This criminal. This David boy gathered them. They attended to Ishilo. The Ishilo that they have been attending for many years. Nothing changes their life. Now they cannot take. The man said, "Come, let us get a good life." They say no. Foolish people. Nonsense.
All right, brother. Thank you. I know how it is in your mind. I know how it is. Sometimes one will go out of emotion. I understand him. He has been in his maybe early 40s or late 40s, and he may see things around. Maybe the prime minister and those that have government government jobs and those that control Italy, maybe they are met. Like here, I am older than the prime minister of this country. I am older than him. I'm well read. You know, he didn't even finish his own university. He dropped out. But yet he's the prime minister. They don't do it by go to school, come out. No. They see what you have inside you. People are naturally intelligent. But where we come from, if you are not a criminal, you cannot even come out to contest for anything. And the good news now is Showore what is his name? Abdul Karim. They are not, and the Charlie Boy, they are now talking about ESN. They have no option. This is the only way to go. And I have to pick like two or three calls and I will call it a day. I have a caller from yes. Can you hear me?
Yeah. Hello.
Yes, where are you calling from, brother? Hello? You know why it's slowing down? From Nigeria. That's their network. But I will assign patient for him to call me +234. You see, others have been calling, is going through. This +234 is calling me now and is holding. You see, network it has caught.
the sign of poverty in that place. Anybody that living there, I pity you. Yes, can you hear me? Plus 44.
I'm good. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you very fast, brother. Where is your name and where are you calling from?
My name is Victor. I'm calling from United Kingdom.
Correct. What do you have for us, brother?
So what the problem is, these Bini people.
Ile Ibinu, from what we've learned.
Even when I meet some of them here in the UK, the way they worship that they are Oba. So I was asking one another that day, has this Oba make your environment to look like Dubai?
For where?
Have this Oba created a job for you people? What is so special about this Oba that you people are worshiping as if he's a god? You know, sometimes, and if you see the way they behave, they all behave like tout.
Yeah, that's what they are, not what they behave. That's what they are. You know? Don't call them, they behave like.
Your upper is just an ordinary human being like you.
Now go to toilet.
They see that their upper as if he's a god. Somebody that is no body.
It's like religion. That is like another form of religion.
Upper has not created a job for you people. Upper, you people are suffering. You are in Europe doing minor job. Suffering from, you know, you're worshiping a man who has not even made a. Assuming upper has done a Bini to look like a Dubai. Or the way the Saudi Dubai king make Dubai to look, or Saudi Arabia. Man, if you're worshipping Oba, you will say, okay, maybe you're worshipping him for something.
Yes.
What are you worshipping your Oba for? And if they all behave like fools. Those that particular people who are worshipping Oba,
exactly.
They don't have common sense.
Exactly.
Man, sometimes when I see them, I just say this, but they don't have brain. Let me let other people to call.
Correct, brother. Thank you very much. Very snappy. I love that. There's no. Let me think. While I was waiting for my leader to speak, this is what he told us. If you are watching me and you are waiting for another thing, listen.
Stay where you are. You mentioned Kosovo, is that correct?
Yes.
Maybe you mentioned Albania, and or maybe you are aware of.
Yeah, we have Macau. This is 2014 when he told us how to get Biafra. So if you are following us and you think they will get Biafra inside the church, stay clear. Those of us are equal to the task, in as much as we find ourselves here. If you are also down home, we will still do the same thing. This world, somebody must rescue somebody. That is how it is. I have you know younger generation that is to come. I will try my best. If you die now, what legacy have you left? Nothing. You are just mug until you go down. I will try this call again from Nigeria to see whether it will go through. Yes, hello?
Yeah.
Where are you calling from, brother? Siam, Nigeria. It is all the call have been calling me from Italy, from UK, from Morocco, Switzerland. See, this one, Nigeria. It hook. Oh, here. They will not understand what is fast internet connection. They will not understand it.
Bosnia has a governor. Do you know Bosnia?
Yeah, Bosnia, Kosovo, and South Sudan.
You said they went to United Nations, is that correct?
Yes.
And they got their freedom?
Yes.
Before they went to the United Nations, did they pick up arms to fight or not?
They did.
Thank you very much. That's what I want to know.
Case closed.
Once you give us guns and weapons, stay in Kuwait, we'll fight at home.
That's the only way.
Listen, if you come now to beat me up, and you keep beating me,
yes.
If somebody is walking past, they will say, "Stop beating him,
please."
But if you beat me, I beat you back. When they come, they will say, "What is the problem?" What is the problem means that you can say your own part, and I will say what happened, and somebody can judge.
Finish.
United Nations will not come to help Biafra until we pick up guns and bullets.
Ew.
Do you know that?
Yeah,
yes, but I think we have fought this struggle before now.
Excuse, give me the excuse.
It's not the same.
At all.
Please, can you tell us?
I will tell you why we did not succeed before. Because of what you yourself just answered now. You said now that if this is only an Igbo cause,
and it will not work. Is that what he said?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Uh-huh. Now we are bringing and taking everybody along.
Igodo, Igodo, he's referring to you people. You are part of what this guy, what our leader is talking now. We are now bringing other people along. We are bringing other people along who have the same ideology with us. That is what he's doing. He know what is this man know what he's doing. Forget that. And he's like most Ile-Ibini people understand him. Most of them have understand. They say, wow, this guy is dragging even some of us. Even it took them only 24 hours to overrun us. Now they are still taking the stronger part of us, which is the Igodomigodo original. And now left for us now that came from Ile-If. And some of us came from Sudan and Mali and Libya. How do we fight them now? Let us continue saying no Biafra, we want one Nigeria.
Everybody along, that is number one. And number two, we stopped fighting.
Yes.
In 1970.
Ojukwu made a mistake. Yes, I'll have to. Our Lord Ojukwu, he made a mistake. He made a mistake to go and start even contesting for Nigerian politics again. That's what, he's a human being. But I have to say he made a mistake. And that is why I love this man now. Since 2013. If you like, I'll play you his first broadcast. Maybe tomorrow I'll replay it. You see how he started. The first broadcast he made here on Radio Biafra. And you check that voice and the tone and what he has been saying till now. Whether is there any difference?
To fight an all-out war, which is total warfare, and there's somebody from the Air Force who is here, maybe he can help us out. We want to fight them, you shoot and we shoot back at you. The whole world ganged up, Britain especially, because Britain knew what they know what it can do. And Britain, listen, people don't know the conspiracy against Biafra. The reason why Biafra has not come is because the likes of Britain don't want Biafra to emerge. If Biafra is standing strong today, every black person on this earth will be liberated. Do you know what I said? Every black man, including Obama, will become free. But they don't want that. They ganged up against us and they killed our people. We should have continued. The birth should have continued. The second army should have gone into the bush to continue guerrilla warfare. That was the greatest mistake of all. We went back to go and reintegrate. When I was talking to very heavy players, big men at UN, what they said to me is, but you stopped. That means that what you're fighting for is not worth dying for. If your freedom is not worth dying for, then the world cannot take you seriously. That is the way it is. Any day, if you like, if you don't, listen, if just do us, I don't need your money, you go now. What we want from you is one container load only.
Yeah, they tell you.
We won't come to you again. Let me tell you, any day they shoot us, police shoot us, we shoot back at them. They kill us, we kill them. Believe you me, UN will come in that same day. But if they're only killing you, UN will say, please, can you investigate the matter? Can you investigate it and make sure that all the culprits are brought to justice? Is that what they will say? But any day police kill us, we kill police back. They will say, please, what is the problem? What is going on? That time the language is not the same. What is going on means they want to hear from the zoo, they want to hear from us. But if they come and they kill us and they go scot-free, they will say to the zoo, please investigate and let us know. Every country you mentioned, the UN came in as they were fighting.
Mm-hmm.
For every year that we fought the war, Southern Sudan fought for 10 years.
Correct.
Guerrilla warfare.
Guerrilla.
At a point, it became very, very clear to Sudanese that you must let these people go. Because they're not going anywhere. They have fought for 30 years, they're not going anywhere.
Our leader, have you heard it? It's very late, here, and I'll be going to work tomorrow. And for those that may be saying Metwisala is drunk, that's why he's talking. No, this is cola. Amanda Nez. You are drunk, that's why you are talking. Look at it here. And I wear Amanda Nez. My eyes are clear, open. My brain are widely open. I know I may pose in this side. Oh no, look, I'm mad when he's at home. Somebody will be drinking and be hiding it. You think it's a red wine. This life is nothing. You have to be yourself. be real and be just be as be contented with the one you have. Don't make like this. All of us are suffering. Anybody that tell you that hey, this is good for me, I'm doing good in Europe, is a bunch of liar. All of us are in this mess. Both the one that I think they are working, we are slaves. Why people allow us to stay? Because most of the many jobs we are doing, their citizens cannot do it. Many 80 like all those daycare, they take care of old women. You see old women that is even about to die, going to toilet, you everything there, you are the one taking care of it. Our brothers and sisters in America, they went there and they tell us they are nurses and medical doctors. Somebody that didn't even go to university here will travel to America, maybe do one course that lasted for 1 year or maybe 1 year, 6 months, and started telling us he's a medical doctor or nurse. That's truth. We need to come out and be telling ourselves. We don't hide ourselves. All of us are in this mess. Whether you lay Ibino, whether you are Igbo speaking Biafran, whether you are Igodo Migodo, even you are Yoruba, anywhere you find yourself in Western world, all of us are in the same mess. And that is why I am hailing the Yoruba people that started, say, at least. Even they have even put it in music. What they want. The same thing with Biafrans. Okay, those now that they say they are not Biafrans, they are Benin Kingdom. Okay, what is your own movement? Which movement have you started? At least you see people say, okay, yeah, they're agitating because they are marginalized. They're agitating for their own nation. Call it something. Start something. Your own is let us restructure Nigeria. Show worry that you people have hope on, have turned to ESN. He's talking about ESN to do something. All this revolution now. They are not talking about ESN to tell you that the only option to go to where we are heading to is just what you just hear now. This call it basis of equality. That is why you can never see America go to Russia be threatening them. Since I know two of them, Cold War. America and Russia in a Cold War. What is Cold War? Oh, I will do this, I will do that, I will sanction you, I will not sanction you. Finish. But if it's Africa, even Agan or they send their hydrogen missile. So what these people have it. So this Ilay Ibini people, you want us to be begging Nigeria, they are killing us. You are begging them. They have been killing us, people are laughing. Hey, IPOB terrorists, IPOB fraudsters, the IPOB fraud, online country. Online country now is giving you people headache. And now you are saying we are drawing map. Don't draw your own map. See, all of, we will, you see, this Ilay Ibini people, we will force you people. We will force you. Anywhere we say you will be. It's the other side of Igodo-Migodo. Those that have been trapped will give chance to decide where they want to go. If it is a referendum, let them decide. For Ilay Ibini, it's not by force. We will force now. Since you now no one wake up, now force. We want to make drag everybody to the mud because of Otobeo. So make we just run away from you people. Respect is reciprocal. Any day you people mind their business. Mind their own business. Let us mind our own business. If you think what we are doing is not right, start your own movement. Let us see who will follow you. Have you seen those you call your kingdom? They have been calling. Even most of the calls I received since I started this program is Igodo-Migodo. I'm telling you. And it's good like that. 80% of the calls I do get here every blessed day, both now and after the program, even tomorrow when I'm not even online, it is people from Igodo-Migodo. They say, our brother, please. I never knew that people are suffocating somewhere, many years. Now they can continue what you are doing. We'll be with you. Most of us have graduated from their university. I have set my own department. Nnamdi Kanu, DOS and others. Struggle for Biafra, fight for the restoration of Biafra. My own, I am for Ilay Ibini. I want to know where the hatred starts from. I want to know the root of the hatred. So that after I have conducted my own analysis, get the root of the problem, I have to hand the file over to whoever that will treat the fuck up. What I'm into now is to try to find out what is this, what is putting these people fear to be fearing their fellow human being in the name of Oba. What is the fear? I want to know What breed that fear? I will respect Oba as my elder. Because Oba is old to be my grandfather. I will respect him as individual. But I can never worship him. And I can never do anything he tell me to do. No man born of a woman is above this law. So for you that have decided to be a slave and you'll be afraid something will happen to you, you must die one day. So the advice I'm going to give you, wake up. Wake up from your slumber. At this point in time, I have to go. I thank you for being with me. Those that I didn't pick your call, I'm very, very sorry for that. I know you must have, you know, a very good contribution towards this project. And my aim, I have already stated it. We Biafrans, freedom of speech must reign in our life. Nobody should be intimidated. I mean, Nnamdi Kanu is like Oba Top Hill. Many people would have fallen. Like there's a one guy every day in home called Ijele. Every blessed day is Nnamdi Kanu. Even he, to the extent of causing them dead mother and the father. But they are walking freely. Nobody, if Nnamdi Kanu is like Oba, many. I don't think many people, he would have killed like millions. Or maybe if Trump is like Oba. Or Jody Bonson, Jody Bonson is like Oba. Or even the Prime Minister here. They draw cartoon, wear his naked, parade nothing. It's a human being. Everybody can make, just to say your mind. Because of Oba, that go to toilet, eat, sleep, bath, laugh, run. I would be afraid of him. For what? I don't know. Maybe you people, I don't know. Maybe it's natural in your life. I know sometimes when we talk, you think brain are the same. All brain are not the same. Maybe this is the way we are. Like our brother says, many people, some people that have been in prison for like the rest of their life, and you open the gate, say they should run away, they will be there looking at you. Say, please lock this gate, please. We are comfortable here. This is what is going on now. So, Ndokwa people is part of us. Ndokwa people, I close this with their music. Very nice one. I hear them. I hear the music, everything, and what they are talking. Ndokwa Kaindozo Bodani. Maybe this is the reason why they are even singing this and that time. I never knew. I saw the music long time ago. And the thing really touches me. I said, wow, really? I think this is my brother. You tried. Yes, can you hear me? I think I wanted to use your call to close this, but I have to disengage. My brother said, I have called many times, bro. I don't know. Unexpected, deported. Yes, I know. The guy is there enjoying the free internet access and so many other things. Our brother that said he just called, please, you have to forgive me. I will be here. We are not going anywhere, but today I think I have to close the program because they say we are jobless, but I'm going to work tomorrow, even though it's not what I merited, but at least I love that at least we work. There are no owners. Since I started working for over getting to 7 years now, they never owe me for 1 cent. They never owe me, or even 8 years now. Every month I will receive my salary. So don't worry, my brother, you will try next time. I thank you for understanding. Let us just close it with this nice one. And I remain your humble servant. Those that have been calling me that I have to be like a gentleman, I have to speak like a gentleman, they try to give me advice that, you try to speak like a learned person. Don't be, the way you talk sometimes, it can make people, do something that they're not supposed to do. I said, no. Forget about those that have been wearing suit and tie. What have they gotten to us? Nothing. A suit or tie does not make one. I am a comfortable madman. I am comfortable with my madness. I cannot change from my way because I want to satisfy other people. Does I want to be there? Maybe if I come out, I wear tie and say, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, we are here to talk about. No, the way I speak, I'm comfortable with it. So, in as much as I take your advice, not every advice I will take, I am myself. and this is how I am. And if you are talking about, if I'm talking restoration of Biafra inside even this Britain or America or this developed country, I will understand you. That advice will make sense. But provided it's Nigeria, you must be like a madman to wake other people up so that they can take challenge. Don't you see what is going on in Nigeria now? Ranging from kidnapping, my hometown today was invaded by kidnappers, and they succeeded in kidnapping the house member. Everywhere, burning of police station, killing of police people, taking their arms. So it is now rampant everywhere. Can't you see what is going on? You don't know what is hunger. You may think it's IPOB or ESN. Hunger is the root of all evil, and people have, they have no money again to steal from the poor people. Now they are going for the those people that are frustrating their life. If your father is a policeman, give him advice. And I have to leave you here. May Chukwuka Abiamah bless you, keep you, and at the same time, keep your brain up. Never you be derailed because of one thing or the other. There's hardship. All of us are suffering. Hold yourself. It's not easy. I know. In our various places, it's not easy. We are suffering. I know. I can see you. Even though I'm not a prophet, you will not believe me because I say I can see you. I know you in your own various endeavors. It is not easy. Especially when you remember people you kept at home. It's not easy. And we have to continue. You may never knew when it will become. But when it comes, it is forever. Nothing good comes easy. Any road that have no obstacle, run away. This road we are taking has so many obstacles. And we must conquer those obstacles. And the ability for you to conquer those obstacles and move on and get to your destination is what makes the journey sweet. And we are going there. So I remain your humble servant, Methuselah Nwanne Melchizedek, signing off from the beautiful city of Biafra. Beautiful city of Biafra, I may call it. This is Vienna. I beg your pardon. This is